Hand off to number 24, Jay Zeng. Loss of a yard on the play. Second and 11 for the Aces.
Hello, hello. Welcome in today on HHS-TV's broadcast of the Harriton Rams football team against the visiting LM Aces. This matchup is featuring the two high schools of Lower Merion School District. Our apologies for coming in a bit late. We were having some technical difficulties, but we should be all good now. All right, and the Aces take the snap. And they find number 25 for the Aces. Oh, and he breaks one tackle, continues to go.
Number four, Jack Lato. Caught by number 25.
It was caught by number 25, Phil Cook, senior there.
For a first down, flag on the play.
Yeah, I think we'll definitely be seeing this a lot today, especially from the running back on that quick screen game coming from the outside. We see that sometimes in a three-receiver set out of LM. And here they come now with the first down on the play with a chance to strike early.
Dead ball personal foul against Harriton.
Oh, and there seems to be a personal foul against Harriton. And that penalty will really hurt the Rams, putting the LM Aces in good field position, very close to field goal range. And, you know, this drive started off slow, Jason, but, you know, it quickly picked up speed. All right, and quarterback lines up in the shotgun. Number four, yeah, Jack Lito.
They come out with a five wide, and here's a motion from the slot. Expect him on the screen.
Oh, and they miss there. He was trying to connect with number 23, Sam Zhang.
Yeah, this is an interesting play call that they come out here with on first and 10. You know, we don't really see a lot of five wide from the Lower Merion Aces. You know, we saw a little bit of three wide last week against Upper Darby. But interesting that they're coming out here aggressive to start this game.
We've already seen Jack Lito test his arm. Let's see if they'll continue to test it.
They're going to keep the left side with three wide. So as a linebacker, I would watch that. Especially coming off the edge.
Lito takes the snap, hands off there. And the Rams stuff the LM Aces. Number 24, Jay Zhang, was getting nowhere on that play. And that brings up a third and 11. Now, Jason, we all know that the troubles that the Harriton Rams football team has had really on both sides of the ball.
Yeah.
If you're Coach Miller, what are you saying to your guys before this game to try to get them pumped, to try to get this team their first win?
Well, I'll tell you what, it is against the Lower Merion Aces, and that is their division rival, or that is their, I should say, inner district rival. You know, they came off a big win last year, 20-0. So just keep that motivation going, and hopefully you can, you know, capitalize on those weaknesses from that you saw earlier in the season.
Lito taking it himself outside, only getting about 4 yards there, trying to bounce it out, but tackled there by, let's see,
carry by
number
four, Jack
11, Jabril Rumpf.
Made by number 55, Gianfranco Colella.
Oh, correction there. Gianfranco Colella is the one who made the tackle for the Rams.
Fourth down.
Bringing up a fourth and 7 for this Aces team in the NFL or college ranks. We might try to see a field goal, but for high school, this is too long a kick. So it looks like this is really four down territory for the Aces. Jason, if you're the LM coach, What type of player are you trying to call up right now?
Well, I'll tell you what. It is 4th and 7, so you're going to have to look for something long down the field. And what we see the LM offense do sometimes is they'll come out with 4 wide. And when they come out in the 4 wide set, I would be expecting a motion or something from the slot and then something like a quick screen pass to them and try to get blockers in front. But that's, you know, you're not always guaranteed long yardage from there. So also, I would also be attacking the middle of the field against a kind of defense that comes out a lot in man coverage. And you could be expecting something like that, maybe like a quick slant or a deep post.
We have already seen Lito go to one of his big tight ends, Phil Cook. And especially in, you know, a mid-range situation to go, he could try to look that way to, you know, hit a big body. We've seen him do that once so far this drive. Lito lines up in shotgun. Takes the snap. Throws it. Incomplete there.
Nice
play. The deflection there looked like seems to be number 30 for the Rams.
Yeah, what they're gonna get there is they're gonna get a curl concept, which are those two slot receivers. They're gonna curl from the inside. They're gonna curl, lining up inside and then curl in. And you know that works a lot against man coverage because again, you know this is a defense that doesn't really have two high safeties. They kind of just keep those safeties like lower on their man. And as a quarterback, you got to be able to read that, attack that coverage quickly, and try to get it on the curl. But that the corner covering there, nice job knocking it away.
And it appears Coach Meller for the Rams,
Harrison,
has called a timeout. A little interesting there why. Seemed as if the Rams were ready to go. Not much confusion, but, you know, maybe he saw something that he didn't like, wanted to make sure that the offense was in sync. So he called the timeout. And, you know, this Harriton Rams, they just came off Friday night. Tough loss to the Pencrest Lions.
It was a tough loss.
It was, you know, really demoralizing to this team. So if you're Coach Miller, what type of plays are you drawing up to get your offense to spark this first drive, really hoping for a touchdown, really just to he would settle for any points on the board? What would you be calling up?
Well, I'll tell you what. I'm going quick passes here, maybe something like a slant from the outside. Here they are coming out in a 3-receiver set. So looking at that, yep, see, there's the motion. Maybe, see, they're in man coverage. Expect something.
And the give there is to number 2, Teddy Molino.
Hand off to number 2,
and
Teddy Molino.
Seems to lose about 2 yards on that play, so that it'll now be second and 12. Teddy Molino, really one of the bright spots for this Harriton Rams team. Plays both offense and defense. Is really the leader of this Harriton team. He's been on the team since freshman year, been on varsity since freshman year. He's the best player on offense. Some consider him the best player on defense. And it'll be interesting to see where he takes his talents next year. The give there again is to Molino. Tries to bounce it outside. Does not escape the Harriton LM defenders, and again seems to lose about a yard.
Yeah, I was talking to Teddy Molino before the game. He wants to go back to back against Lower Mayor, and I would think he would probably speak for everyone on that offense and that defense and everyone right now, probably looking to get another win against Lower Mayor. You know, both these teams 0-4, trying to come out here and make a statement with their first win of the season.
There seems to be a bit of confusion.
Yeah, they almost had 12
Rams
men
part.
On the field.
They did almost have 12 men on the field. Oh, and there is the flag. It looks as though they will be calling.
It is against the Rams.
Against the Rams there. So
yeah, there's that 12-man call.
With too many men there, that's a 5-yard penalty. This brings up a 3rd and 19 for the Rams. And, you know, you talked about Coach Meller wanting to be aggressive. But really, what play are you calling up here if you're Coach Meller?
Well, something that the offense has really struggled with is attacking deep down the field. So maybe we might not see something that, like, you know, that sort of, you know, not something like, you know, a go route or a fly route from the outside. I think we'll probably be seeing something along the inside. Right now, LM does come out with 1 high safety. They're in man coverage, so they're probably going to attack there.
And Rothberg taking the shot there. Oh! Almost got the grab there from Jonathan Majobe. Junior for Harriton, And that was the first play all game that we saw Rothberg take a shot. Do you think we're going to be seeing a lot of those throughout the game, Jason?
You know, it's interesting because something that is in common between these two teams are that they both play man coverage a lot. And, you know, that LM team, they did come out in man coverage on that play. I think as a quarterback, they feel confident in Rothberg attacking that coverage. You know, the outside is something that they can utilize. And so maybe. We'll see. It depends what LM comes out with.
Harriton punting there. And it looks like the LM Aces will be getting the football at about the 48-yard line, setting them up for great field position.
At the 48-yard line. First down, Lower Merion.
And, yeah, here come the Aces offense now on the field, trying to capitalize off their last drive.
You know, it's interesting to see this Harriton Rams team punt as – against Pencrest, they did not attempt a punt until the second half.
You are absolutely right. That was two fourth down attempts on the first drive alone in last week's loss to Pencrest. Another four wide set here.
Lido takes the snap, drops back, tries to run up the middle. Seems as though he loses the football. And let's see what the ref signal. Football. That's going to be Harriton football.
Look at that, turnover right out of the gate.
And that has to be great for the feeling of this Rams team.
Absolutely.
You know, they had not a great first drive. And with this field position, it also sets up their offense to try to make a good, clean drive here.
I think this is the game that everyone probably looks forward to on both sides, Lower Merion and, of course, Harriton, just being your inner district rivals. And being able to make a statement against them. I think that's something that every school looks forward to.
The ref's talking it over. They seem to have found a good spot. Rothberg in the shotgun here. Pitches it to Molyneux. Molyneux tries to throw it.
Going out of the bag of tricks to start off the first quarter. Going to the back of the playbook to trying to throw off this coverage.
You know what? I like the call there from Coach Miller, as it was definitely something new. And, you know, against these two teams, it's easy to try to predict some of the plays.
Right,
you know, he was trying to throw off the defense there. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it may work. Now they might think twice about going after Molyneux the next time they give it to him.
They come out with a four wide, and there's no safety in the middle of the field here. I think you got to look at the one-on-one coverage there and attack Aiden Newman.
Rothberg drops back. Tries to give it to Molyneux there, but it was incomplete.
That play was set up to go to Teddy Molyneux on the screen. But, you know, if they were to pass there, again, they had no safety in the middle of the field. They had one-on-one coverage on the outside against 23. So if you want to play aggressive, and I know Coach Miller likes to play aggressive, and probably attack that.
Couple of whistles here. They seem to be an injured LM player. He walked off under his own ability, though, which is good to see.
And now they're going to go five wide here. Looks like
Rothberg, shotgun. There's motion. Gives it to Molyneux. There's a hole in the middle. Oh, but he's tackled by number four, Lido, playing both quarterback and linebacker. That sets them up here for fourth and seven, and it looks like the Rams are going to punt.
All right, so it's unfortunate for the Rams that they couldn't capitalize off the turnover. You know, so obviously gifted the ball and trying to make a chance to go down the field and score. And now they're going to give the ball right back to the Aces.
Harriton punts it. Pretty high punt.
Sky kick.
Taken there by number eight for LM, Andre Gilmore. And he takes it to about the 30, 34.
Taken by number eight, Andre Gilmore.
So, Jason, you mentioned this before. There is a storied history here. What type of emotions do you think are going into this game from both sides.
I think they just got to give it everything they got here, and especially in a game like this, and then the situation that we're living in right now with the coronavirus affecting the season. You know, they weren't even scheduled to play Lower Merion, so I think they're putting their heart and soul into this game.
And the play there is blown dead before the snap. Looks to be a false start against LM, so it'll set up a first and 15 for them. The LM cheerleaders trying to get this LM team into the game. Really, no side has been able to sustain a nice offensive drive. We saw a couple of nice plays from the LM offense on their first drive, but they weren't able to capitalize. And from there, it's been a lot of runs, you know, one turnover,
right,
and not much production.
And the quarterback's going to line up under center here, something that they do a lot.
Pitches it to 24, Jay Zhang. And he powers through there to get about 3 yards. But again, the LM defense was pretty much over that play.
Something interesting about that play is, and Harriton has experience of going up teams that are run heavy, like Marble Newtown in their first game of the season. Picking up the motion of the fullback is something that this team has struggled with a lot. What they'll do is they'll motion the fullback to the side that they're going to run the ball on, and then they'll hand the ball off to that side. And, you know, this is a team that doesn't really play with two high safeties, so those outside linebackers really puts emphasis on them to try to make the play.
Lido takes the snap, throws out wide, finds his man, number 8 there, Andre Gilmore. And that was a very nice play there for the Aces, getting about 10 yards there.
Andre Gilmore.
They'll still be short about 3 yards, and it looks as though the punting team for LM is coming onto the field.
Something that that Harriton does and that LM does that's very drastic is
Oh, no, wait. It looks like they're going to be going for it.
Well, LM, they'd come out with a lot of different receiver sets. Like, right now, they're coming out with only one. So, usually, in this case, that corner definitely anticipating something.
Lido under center, looking for his wide receivers. Isn't able to connect there with Phil Cook.
Number 4, Jack Lado, incomplete.
It was 4th and 2, and they're going for the crossing route for Cook. They covered it well.
Brings up 4th and 2 for the Aces.
We were mistaken. Now it is 4th down, and the punting team is coming out for the LM Aces.
Got to change that scoreboard, though.
Looks as though number... Hard to see from here. We will get you the LM punter in one moment.
Just think how they block on that play.
And Molyneux picks up the ball after letting it bounce for
a couple of seconds.
That play was quite reminiscent of the Harriton LM game last year, to try to get the Rams onto the scoreboard at the end of the first half. Molyneux again let the punt roll for a couple of seconds, sort of catching the LM defenders off guard. Then he would pick it up, run it across the side, and then turn it upfield. But on that play, LM had certainly learned from its experience and were ready for Molyneux to pick up the punt. Rothberg takes the snap, gives to Molyneux, bounces it outside, tries to get free, and picks 8 on that play.
Yeah, they put Matt Krebs out. They lined him up in the slot, and they had him do a kick-out block towards the interior of the offensive line. Probably gave Molyneux an extra 2 yards on that play.
That was the best play so far for the Rams on offense. And we see number 10 in the game, Jonas Epstein, a freshman.
Something interesting is there's not a lot of empty sets here in high school.
Passes it out there to Molyneux. Molyneux, quickly realizing that he had thrown it backwards, was able to jump on the ball before any LM defenders were really able to get to
it. That's a smart player right there. It's definitely a smart play, and it was a little bit behind. Didn't really look like there were a lot of blocks developed anyway, but obviously smart play there by Molyneux, being able to jump on the ball and eliminate any sorts of fumble or turnover.
Rough sequence, though, there for the Rams as it now backs them up to 3rd and 10 once again. We could see Rothberg here take a shot to the outside with Aiden Booman Newman.
But they are heavily favoring that left side.
Oh, and the pass was blocked by number 57, David Schaefer. Oh, correction.
By number 50, Andrew Cook.
Number 50 for LM, Andrew Cook.
It is going to bring up a 4th and 10. Definitely not the start to the first quarter that either teams were expecting. I think they wanted to start out of the gate sort of aggressive.
Number 8, Andre Gilmore.
At the 30-yard line, it'll be interesting to see what sort of LM field position comes about.
It's a high kick again.
And another high kick for the Rams, almost blocked again by LM. And it seemed as though the receiving team for LM, one of their players had accidentally touched the ball, but then quickly fell on it.
Ball will be placed at the 30-yard line. First and 10.
It is a cold night out here at Harriton on the field.
That definitely could be affecting some of the hands of both teams.
They're definitely affecting my hands, I'll tell you that. We're all bundled up here, other than my hands.
With little action happening so far in the first quarter, it'll be interesting to see, you know, what type of game dominance the first team to score will have once they do first get that score.
There is an offset eye. I think they're heavily anticipating that run.
And Lito there gives to Zhang. Powers through for about 3 yards. 4 yards.
Something that I would do if I were both teams, or especially Lower Merion there with the struggling run defense like the Harriton Rams, I definitely, you know, establish a run game first, start by running the ball, then you got to hit the quick game. You know, this is an offense for Lower Merion that comes out, like I said, in a lot of different receiver sets. So they can come out in like a 4-receiver set and hit a quick game, and then obviously return back to the run, and then maybe go play action. But I don't think we're going to be seeing a lot of play action from Harriton. I think we're going to see mostly quick passes and lots of runs here.
Lito again under center. Gives to Zhang. Big hole there. Oh, and there's a flag, but he breaks free. Zhang to the house. Number 24, Jay Zhang on that play, but it looks like it is going to be called back.
You know what was very effective on that run? It was a fake to the fullback. They actually faked to the fullback and then went to the opposite side. So when you do that, it's interesting because you come out in that formation that anticipates the defense is coming to the left or to the right, and they fake to the fullback, and the defense starts shifting to that fullback, anticipating the run. And then they hand it off to the left side to the running back, who then obviously takes it to the house there. So it was an effective play.
Against Lower Merion.
But it is going to come back.
With a holding call against LM that negates really the whole play. In fact, looks like it'll back them up by a few yards. Second and short here coming up. If you're the coach of LM, you can't be happy. You almost had a touchdown right there to get your team on the board, but penalties, penalties, penalties. Lito under center.
Another offset eye.
Gives it to Jay Zhang again. Tries to bounce it outside. Is stuffed there by the Harriton defense.
Hand off to number 24, Jay Zhang.
Yeah, obviously, you know, this is a type of formation that's really common in high school. It's called the offset eye formation, where you take a fullback and you offset him out of the eye. And, you know, a lot of defenses anticipate whatever side that fullback is lined up on. That's the side that the run's going to go. Now, on the touchdown play, they actually faked the fullback and handed it to the running back, who took it to the left side for the touchdown.
Some creative play calling on that play. And it looks like they gave the first down to LM. So, 1st and 10 now. Lito under center. Gives to Zhang. Bounces it outside. Tackled there by number 11, Seth Flazar.
Yeah, I like Seth Flazar on this team. You know, something that I think that most teams, especially Lower Merion, should include in their offense are up the middle runs against a struggling interior defensive line. It allows more anticipation from the linebackers, and if you know teams with struggling middle linebackers and sort of linebackers that anticipate the run, it's good to just attack that first.
LM has now run on the last several plays. If you're the Harriton defense, you should be expecting that again. But Lito, in the shotgun now, tries to run it himself up the middle, is powering through, and they might give him the first down for this.
You know, out of the screen game, obviously he faked the screen there to the running back and then kept it himself, but out of the screen game, something we see a lot from this offense are motions first. So if I'm the Harriton defense, I'm watching for those motions. And then once they motion, make sure that you have your guy locked in. So if they hit the quick screen, you're able to sort of get to the player first and make the tackle. And if you're a little late there, then he can brush past you. Cheerleaders really happy here with that first down.
And the Harriton cheerleaders were not able to make it. With less than 20 seconds
watch
here.
Watch the A-gap. You're going to get pressure right up there.
Lito gives it to Zhang. Tripped up there by the Harriton defense. But again, as this first quarter is coming to an end, Jason, we've seen a lot of runs, you know, that fill the gaps and then bounce out, you know, really from both teams. But it seems as though LM has sort of been executing so far a little better than the Rams. And really, what do you make of that?
Well, I'll tell you what I saw right there on that play is they're going to bring pressure up the middle, and then that causes the running back to bounce the run outside. So you're really going to be relying on those outside receivers and those tackles to make those blocks so you're able to maneuver your way around them. So that's really behind the whole kicking out the run story, because they're going to send pressure right up the middle. They're going to make you take the run to the outside. And that's what we just saw right there on that play. I really like the Lower Merion playbook, though. They have a lot of creative plays. You know, I've been able to sit back, watch some of their plays against Upper Darby. You know, I think they get creative when they put three receivers on the field, so I'd watch out for that tonight. Definitely a lot of screen passes off of motions as well. So.
And this Harriton offense has not been able to get into any sort of a rhythm. And we've noticed a couple names that have not yet been called tonight. Most notably, Seth Flazar on the offense, who was the Rams' number one target against Pencrest. And as well, Aiden Booman Newman.
Booman Newman, that's what they call him.
Booman Newman, his last name Newman, nickname Booman, has, you know, been their main threat on the outside, but, you know, Rothberg has not gone to either of them all game.
Watch those outside linebackers. See how they drop back?
Lito trying to get it outside, and Molino going after him, can't make the tackle.
Something interesting about these linebackers is that, especially the ones on the outside, they drop back, anticipating a pass. I think something that would really take to the advantage for the Harriton defense is sort of implementing a cover four, which sounds complicated, but it's not. It's when they take two corners and they put them in two deep zones, and they take your two safeties, put them in two deep zones. That sort of puts the emphasis on your linebackers. It's good against the run, too, because those middle linebackers were able to, you know, swarm that gap and stop the run.
And with that play, the LM Aces were able to pick up a first down. Lito under center now. Gives to Jay Zhang. Tries to find a hole. And cuts back the other way. And he fumbles the ball. And let's see what the refs say. They're saying that it went out of bounds before anyone could recover. So that's going to be a loss of about a yard on this play to make it second and 11.
Yeah, once again, end of the offset eye formation. You're going to kick it out to the left side. And then right there, I guess he didn't see anything, so we took it back around to the right.
Second and 11 for Lower Merion.
Able to, you know, eventually, you know, lost a yard on the play after the fumble. But second and 11, try to get some sort of space after the run.
And we've seen LM mainly use Jay Zhang as their primary offensive weapon. If you're the LM defense, Jason, what are you doing to try to contain him?
Well, if I'm the Harriton defense, I'll tell you what. I'm definitely looking to seal those outside, especially because that's where the runs are going, especially out of this formation right here. That was just an offset eye. So that fullback probably going to block that the left side, and the run would be going to the left side. So as the defense, I would be making sure that those outside outside is sealed, and then the middle linebackers have to stay in the middle, because if he breaks through the middle and that linebacker is not there, he's gone. Just nothing but green grass for him at that point. So definitely look for that as the defense, and that's probably what Coach Miller is trying to get the message out to his linebackers.
LM taking a timeout there. Both teams have now used at least one timeout.
Approaching the 11:40 mark here of the first half.
So under 12 minutes here in the second quarter. Neither team yet to score. And so far, the game has mostly been in favor of LM, but really, with no points on the board, it's anybody's game.
Yeah, it looks like they are going to come out in a two-back set with the fullback aligned to the strong side.
Lito under center.
There it is again.
Gives it to Zhang. Keeps cutting. And gets about 10 yards there.
Number 24, Jay Zhang on
seems
the carry.
To be about 1 yard shy of the first. But again, we see
tackle
Jay Zhang
and again
really producing for this LM offense. If I am the LM coach, I am continuing to give it to Jay Zhang until this Harriton defense can come up with a stop.
Third and two.
And again, it's, a lot of teams have utilized runs to the outside against this defense. And, it's working again for this Lower Merion offense. They're able to sort of tire them out, switch the runs from the left to the right. And look at that. See how there's no one in the middle of the field?
Lito, shotgun, tries to run it himself. Gets a few more yards before being tackled.
Jack
picks up the first down there.
Now, I'll tell you what the quarterback was thinking there. He was thinking, there's no safeties in the middle of the field. There are no linebackers in the middle of the field. If I keep it myself and I get past one of those linebackers, I can probably score here. Like, there's just no one there to stop me. So that's exactly what he did, but he ran up that A-gap, and luckily one of the outside linebackers was over there to make the tackle before and probably sealed a touchdown.
Even when Lito has been in shotgun, he hasn't really been tested with his arm. He's under center now.
This time they're going to line the fullback to the weak side.
Giving it to Zhang again. Goes up. One man to beat. Touchdown LM.
All right. I'll tell you what I saw there. You want me to tell you what I saw there? I saw a fake to the fullback and a give to the right side to the running back. And that is the same play that they ran when they scored that touchdown over there before that got called back by the flag. So just punching LM right in the – or punching Harriton right in the mouth as they utilize the same play that they have on that last touchdown. Fake to the fullback, hand off to the running back, take it to the other side. Something that the defense does not anticipate. They expect that run to the left, and he just took it to the right, took it to the distance.
On to attempt the extra point, number 27.
Great decision.
Now on the extra point for LM is number 27. And the kick is good. With that
extra point
that
good.
Makes the score LM 7,
score,
Harriton nothing.
Seven, Harriton
and
zero.
On that drive, we saw that the LM offense just kept giving it to Jay Zhang. Basically, every single play was a run, mostly to the outside with
right.
Jay Zhang.
Right.
A couple of Lito runs up the middle where he carried it himself. But with the Harriton offense, how long do you think it'll take them to really come up with a way to stop Zhang? Because they did not show it on that last drive.
Until they are able to put pressure, or until they're able to disrupt the backfield, then that's when LM will start going to someone else or sort of open up new pages up in their playbook. The quarterback really only keeps when you have no one in the middle of the field, and when those outside linebackers are sort of pushed out towards the middle of the field and sort of that middle part, that's when you hand off to the outside, and they come out with that again, and a creative play with the fullback fake. That's a touchdown.
LM kicking off. Harriton receives at the 20. Molyneux there. Bounces it to the outside. Gets the edge at the 50. Gets tripped up.
Returned by number two, Teddy Molyneux.
Gets to the LM 42-yard line before tackled down. This gives the Harriton offense a great opportunity here with amazing field position.
First down, Harriton.
It seems as though Teddy Molyneux is almost willing this Harriton team to try to get into this game.
Well, I mean, he plays both kick returner and running back, so. And defense. He plays special teams, offense, and defense, so definitely a big part.
Every single play, Molyneux is out there. Now, this Harriton offense coming out. Yeah. Rothberg telling something to his backs.
I do think they should attack a quick slant or something like that.
Rothberg?
Because there's going to be no pressure off the left side, or right side. Just attack
Rothberg
that.
Giving it to 16 for the Rams. Jonathan Majobe, who gets tackled there for a loss of about 4.
I'll tell you what I see if I'm Logan Rothberg right now. I'm looking at the defense, and I'm looking at which side the pressure comes from. If it comes from the left side, hit something off the right side, okay? So if you want to do, like, a quick slant or something like that, that's fine. But just make sure you're not throwing to the side where the pressure comes from, because they might not pressure every play. They could drop back into coverage, and if they read that right, they could intercept it. So I'd definitely be careful of that.
Rothberg under it. Our producer is freaking out a bit right now. And the pass there was to number 12, Seth Flazar. First target all game. The pass was low from Rothberg.
Pass incomplete.
And
target number 12, Seth Flazar.
This now brings up a 3rd and 16.
Brings up 3rd and long.
With this great field position, I'm sure Coach Miller is, you know, wanting to take advantage. What play call do you have right now to make sure that this Rams offense picks up the first down?
Well, it's 3rd and 16, and this is a team that plays a lot of cover one. So definitely you're going to want to isolate your receivers out wide, which they are doing right now, and they're going to want to attack the sidelines.
Rothberg, under pressure there, just had to get rid of it.
Pass from number 10, Logan.
Seemed
Rothberg
as though the offensive line was trying to set
11,
up for a bubble screen, but Rothberg wasn't able to find him there.
Brings up 4th and long.
And
for the
this
Rams.
Harriton offense squandering the great field position given to them by Molyneux.
Yeah.
And, I mean, really, if they're going to ever get back into this game, they're going
to
need to produce on offense.
Area,
it can't just be
Sam
hoping that, you know, they get some sort of a return or something.
Yeah, I think if you're Coach Mella, you're definitely sort of you're not happy with what's going on now on the field.
Harriton?
They definitely do not want to give the ball back to LM with the lead.
High punt there. And it seemed as though...
Did they muff it?
No, the Harriton players seem to think that the LM, one of the returners, touched the ball, and now Harriton has the ball. But there is no signal here from the referees. I think they're looking to see who has it.
It's always harder in high school because, you know, you don't have the replay system that they do in college and the NFL. So it becomes really complicated to anticipate or to try to figure out who has the ball.
So it seems as though they are going to be giving it to LM. But 2 scares there on the punt team for LM. I'm sure that the LM coach, Joe Augustine, is going to be going over that with them tomorrow. And
yeah,
Lito.
Defense should really be shifting to the left side because that's where the fullback is lined up on.
Lito under center.
It's going left.
Gives it to Zhang. Tries to bounce it out. There's a flag. Not able to get anything there. In fact, about
Jay
a loss.
Zhang.
A loss of about 1.
Tackle made by number 11.
But
Matt
there
Kripp.
Is a flag on the play.
Yeah, I think with the linebackers.
And seems to be holding on the offense, so that'll cost them another 10 yards to set up first and 20.
I think what the linebackers want to do is they're trying to read the quarterback's eyes, and I think that's what they're, you know, that's what they're taught. That's what they're taught to do. As, you know, Mike linebacker and strong safeties and free safeties, they're taught to read the quarterback's eyes. But if they come out in that formation, you got to look at the fullback, because whatever he, whatever direction he goes in is probably going to be the direction that the run goes. And if they don't, then that could be the difference between 2 yards and 5 yards. And again, they have an offset. So, and the quarterback is under center.
Quarterback under center. Gives to Zhang. Chased down there by number 74 on Harriton. The defensive lineman there was able to get to Zhang before he was able to go anywhere. And that tackle was made by number 74, Robert Tiska, who's a senior.
Well, if we had a Surface Pro 3 right now, I would be drawing up the circles around Teddy Molino, who just ran across the field because he knew where that run was going. You could see him, he was lined up on the left side of the field, and right when before they even snapped the ball, he just ran all the way to the right side of the field, anticipating that run to the right, which is interesting because the fullback was lined up on the left side. So definitely a great read from Molino.
Four wide receivers for LM, Lito in the shotgun.
They're going strong.
Drops
trips
back
on the left.
Dumps it off to Zhang, and he takes it for about 8 yards there.
So this is a strong trips formation where they take three receivers and they trip them up to one side, and that isolates your fourth receiver on the other side of the field, and that's going to be one-on-one coverage. So unless they are pressuring that side, I'm attacking that. I'm attacking the one-on-one.
With third and 12 here, it'll be interesting to see what the defense comes up with here, because again, you have to be expecting.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's not cover four. I'll tell you, it's not cover four. And they are having no safety.
Nito takes the shotgun. In the shotgun, takes the snap. Receiver turns back.
Oh,
and that's going to be a flag. Molino there hitting the receiver. As what seemed like when the ball was getting there, but the refs disagreed. It's going to be a pass interference against Molino, and that'll really help out this LM offense, as should give them about 20 yards.
You want to know what would have been a nice defensive play? Cover four. You got three safeties back, or two safeties back there, two corners back there on the deep coverage. Definitely would have eliminated that, but if they come out into man coverage, then you're gonna go deep. If it's third and long or second and long, maybe not second and long, but third and long, and it's man coverage, you're going deep, especially when you attack that.
That's a tough play there for Molino, because again, that was one of the only plays where Lito's arm was tested, and his arm didn't really deliver there. You know, the pass was somewhat high.
And he was open too. I would have tested that as well.
And
if I was the
he wasn't able to get it to his receiver, so that play for Molino just wasn't really necessary there. The give now is to Zhang up the middle. Doesn't get much there. Maybe a gain of two or three.
And off to number 24, Jay Zhang.
Jay Zhang, their workhorse back.
Made by number 7, Ben Fisher.
Yeah, Mr. Fisher made that tackle. I talked to Fisher before the game. So happy to be on the field right now. So happy to be playing. He's a junior, so he's going to get another season, obviously, for his senior year. But obviously, he has a huge love for the game. I've known him since I was probably in, like, third grade, and he's always loved football. It's always been a big passion of his life. So it's good to see him out here.
Indeed.
And, wow, look at that. And they are coming out with one high safety in those corners. They're counting the drop back.
Lito there. Finding his tight end, Phil Cook. The big body there, not able to be taken down. It only...
Pass completed from Jack Lato.
They needed four Harriton defenders to take Phil Cook down. That was a very nice read there from Lito to get his big tight end the ball.
It absolutely was. And I'll tell you what they did. It was a curls concept where you take your outside receivers, you put them on curls, and your slot receivers go deep. That's important, especially because of this formation, those are of the defensive formation, the two corners, or if you watch their eyes, they were watching the quarterback. They were dropping back, anticipating something deep. So as a quarterback, the way you attack that is you find the soft spot in the coverage and deliver. It's all about timing on that play.
Lito signaling for motion, pitches it to Zhang. Should mention not Jay Zhang there, but Sam Zhang.
I'll tell you what we saw there, though. Out of a three-receiver set, something that I talked about a lot in the beginning of this broadcast, when they come out in a three receiver set, something I'd be expecting is one motions, and we just saw three receiver set and a motion and a screen pass to the slot receiver.
As we mentioned a bit earlier, sports in Pennsylvania and really the rest of the country in terms of high school sports are somewhat up in the air right now. This could end up being Harriton's final game of the season. Many people didn't think that this game was going to be possible.
I believe they're scheduled to play Ridley this Friday.
I believe so, but again, with everything going
right,
on.
Right, yeah,
we really have no idea. We were sent home Monday, and
ball was placed
you know,
at the 14-yard line. First
we are not
10,
going back
Marion.
For, you know, about 2 months. So it'll be interesting to see what happens with the remaining games. Lito here in the shotgun.
Takes a low snap.
Just has to go with it. He breaks the tackle, and there's a touchdown there with Lito on the carry. Oh, but there seems to be a flag.
Well, they were pro-gun. That's two receivers outside. Usually that indicates an outside run to the strong side. And, you know, we saw the strong side, but it was a low snap, but he did take it to the strong side. So, obviously a positive play resulted in a touchdown.
There does seem to be a penalty here. Let's see what it is. And must have been on the defense.
I think it is against the defense. I think they're probably going to get holding.
It was declined. Enforced on the kickoff. So with this kick.
He's a lefty kicker.
The kick is up and good, making the score 14-0 in favor of LM. Now,
by Jack Lato, the score.
Jason, if you are Coach Meller and the opposing quarterback just scored on a
broken play. Yeah.
What are you saying to your team right now as he has his entire team in the huddle right now?
Yeah, he's definitely talking to them. You know, in football terms, he's probably asking them to seal the edge because that's where all of these scores are going. You know, we saw the cutback lane off the first touchdown, and we saw a broken play. I think the play was designed to the left. I think it was supposed to be to the left on that play, just because of the way the formation looked. But he's definitely talking, especially those linebackers, the ones who were supposed to be sealing the edge, the defensive ends as well. You know, anticipate the play. And is that Molino limping on the sideline?
Nope, he is out there for the play. He might be using a little stronger language than "let's go, guys," but understandable here. And
probably going over the scoring plays and what went wrong.
And with the penalty being enforced here, the LM team is actually kicking from the Harriton 45. So let's see that type of field position.
They're
going
to squib it.
Squib kick here. And Harriton's taken down at the 30-yard line. Again, pretty good field position for the kick. You know, meeting the return and from where it was kicked about, you know, in the middle. Mm-hmm. Return there from Ben Fisher. And, you know, it's an interesting call from LM to squib it.
Right.
But I think that they were going into that kick thinking, you know, their big plays have come when we've kicked it. So, mm-hmm. You know, let's take that away. Let's make their offense.
Let one of
us.
The up men kick it up, not Molino. You're right. You're absolutely right. I agree with you.
Rothberg.
Something about the scheme is they're both 3-4. So you got three linebackers, four defensive linemen.
Rothberg gives it to Molino. Cuts back to the middle. Taken down there from behind
by number 25,
Phil Cook. Cook getting it done now on both offense and defense.
Now, I'm not quite sure if they audible in high school, but if they do, then that's definitely something that you should have audibled away from, especially that run with the pressure coming off both sides, attacking the middle of the field there with one safety, and now there's no safety, so definitely full-on man coverage here.
Gives to Molino again. A bit more successful this time. Gains about 5 yards to set up a third and about four.
they were crashing the line there with about six LM defenders. So I'd honestly feel pretty happy with the gain that they just got from there, especially with all the defenders sort of crowding that line of scrimmage.
Rothberg here in the shotgun. Let's see if he'll
see how they stack the box. They're gonna motion, and they're obviously in man coverage, so they're anticipating that run.
Rothberg giving it to Molyneux, cuts it outside.
Oh, big hit.
Takes a big hit there, but does pick up the first down for the Rams.
Tackle made.
Bouncing off some of the defenders there.
I think Lower Merion probably thought that run was going to go to the right just because of the motion and the way how they usually when you motion the slot receiver and he'll service the blocker. But Molyneux kicked it out to the left side where there was less LM defenders as the right side.
Rothberg takes the snap there. Seemed to be false start there on the Rams. And that'll cost him 5 yards to set up a first and 15. It seemed as though the Harriton Rams were, trying to go for a big play on that one.
Right.
But, maybe some of the receivers got a little jumpy.
And, those are the kind of plays that they need. The only really pass plays we've seen in this game are screen passes, short screens, off of motions. If they're in man coverage, then throwing a screen might not be the most effective way of picking up yardage.
Oh, and number 10 takes the snap there. He's going to throw it into double coverage, and of course it gets picked off. LM taking it the other way. He's got a lane. Molyneux trying to meet him. He'll break that tackle, but he will get pushed out of bounds at the 4-yard line.
That's 4 interceptions in 2 games now. He threw 3 last week. Rough sight there for the Harrison offense. He threw it up into double coverage. Now, that was interesting because they were in that man coverage. So he rolled out to the right side and threw it up there. And when you're a safety, they had one high safety. So when you're a safety, you watch the quarterback. And if he's going to roll to the right, you're going to roll to the right too. Because obviously, you don't really throw across the field. So when you roll to the right, that safety followed with him. And he threw it deep. And that safety was right there to get the interception and double coverage. Definitely.
Under center now. The give is to Zhang.
Good stop.
Gets swallowed up. If you're the Harriton defense right now, you should absolutely be packing the box because, they've beaten you on running the ball.
Right.
And they haven't really been able – they've beaten you somewhat passing it, but on this short yardage situation, it's very likely that they're going to keep running it until they hope they get in. And the Rams hope they stop them.
Well, I'll tell you what we're not going to see. We're probably not going to see your receivers out wide here on this play. Definitely a lot of tight formation.
Oh, and it looks like they are going to be going out wide with Lido in the shotgun.
Well, they are on the two, so they'll probably be.
Lido there rolling out. Looks like he's going to try to take it himself. And he'll get there for his second rushing touchdown of the game.
Well, I'll say this, though. They put the receivers out wide. They weren't going to throw to them because you can't – when you have 4 receivers out wide, you can't have all of them on short passes, especially when you come out with trips. So – because usually when they come out with trips and you're going to pass the ball, those receivers are going deep, and they're obviously not going to run deep here inside the 5-yard line. So that play was fully designed for a run. They definitely were not going to pass that ball.
LM again attempting another extra point. And once more, it is straight through, up and good. And with that extra point, that brings the score to LM 21, Harriton 0. In fact, I might be wrong on this, but that is almost exactly the same score but reversed from the Harriton LM game last year.
Well, I believe it was 20-0, but yeah, pretty much on the mark.
So very similar. So, Jason, what do you account the difference for from that game till this game? Because really, 2 different shows.
Right, and not in favor of Harriton for this show, unlike last year. So, it's a It's definitely struggling on the interior and struggling to seal the gaps. And, you know, obviously last year, Harrison or LM, they didn't put any points up on the board, so they definitely did a good job stopping the run in that game and sort of eliminating passes on the outside and or the perimeter and the inside. So
another squib kick here from LM, taken here by Ben Fisher. Tries to go to the other sideline.
Returned by number 7, Ben Fisher.
Doesn't get there, but he does give the Rams pretty good field position at the 36-yard line for the Rams.
First and 10, Harriton.
And Rothberg so far has not had a great game. The only time that he's been tested with his arm, he's thrown an interception.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you know,
this is just, you know, it's sort of history repeating itself. We saw this last week against Pencrest right here on the same field, 3 interceptions in the loss.
That's right. And the give there is to Molino. Oh, and he gets free. He's going. No one's going to catch him at the 10, at the 5. Touchdown, Rams.
Touchdown, Harriton.
Touchdown from Teddy Molino. What a great play there from the senior running back.
I think it was the right tackle was able to seal. It was a kick out block. He was able to seal the left side.
And that run there was 63 yards, by far the longest play of this game for either team, possibly the longest play of the season for the Rams. And, I mean, if you're asking for a spark, you couldn't do any better than that.
Well, it was definitely the longest touchdown of the season. I believe last year or last week they did have a 64-yard run with Teddy Molino, but the drive ended in a punt, believe it or not. But here they are, and they are going to go for 2.
Going for 2 here.
4 wide.
Oh, and it seems to be a false start, but picked up by Rothberg. Let's see what the call is here. An interesting call from Coach Meller to go for 2.
Kind of reminds me of the Eagles. They go for 2 a lot. Just saying. They do go for 2 a lot.
It is Doug Peterson-esque. Some say if he hadn't gone for 2 the second time, it might have helped us out last game. But we're not going to talk about that for right now. And let's see what the refs are talking to Meller about. He seems to not be in agreement or be angry, but looks as
though. I think he probably does not like the false start play, the false start call. But regardless, that will bring the ball in possession to Lower Merion.
So it seems as though they're not replaying it. They are just counting that as, you know, a strip sack recovered by the Rams. So with that failed two-point conversion, that cuts the LM lead down to 15. So still ways away to go for the Rams, but with just over a minute left in this second quarter, that's definitely a positive sign of the Rams for Coach Meller.
And the Lower Merion Aces will now receive the ball.
The Rams somewhat squib it, somewhat onside kick it, but LM, they break a tackle there and get pushed out at about the Rams' 49-yard line. So great field position to start for the LM Aces. It'll be interesting to see how the LM Aces have responded because, you know, as soon as they started scoring, up until that last play, Harriton hadn't put up any fight against it. Now Harriton is starting to show some fight. So, you know, first time all game that the LM Aces will, you know, have to respond. And almost picked off there by, Josh Cave got his hands on it.
By number 9, Joshua Cave.
Right.
And
yeah, they pretty much ran what's similar to a smash concept, which is when you take your slot receiver and you put him on an out route, and you take your outside receiver and you put him on a fly route. And that pretty much, it gives you the option to either pass underneath or you can hit the long pass to either the deep out or the fly route. And they chose to go down that road. And Harriton read it well. Incomplete.
Again, though, with Lito being tested, you know, throwing the ball through the air.
Four wide
he
again.
He hasn't been able to do much. Passes it there to number three on LM.
Pass completed from number four, Jack Leo,
Lance Kim.
To number three, Lance Kim.
But there are flags after the play. And it might go against Harriton here. Unnecessary roughness, possibly.
Now they are coming out here on a second and 10. Probably run the ball here.
Personal
give him some space.
A face mask.
It is going to be a 15 yards, and it will be an automatic first down, so abandon that.
A 15-yard penalty. I mean, that's killer for the Rams. They have under a minute left, and, you know, coming off of a touchdown, all that the Harriton defense needs to do is keep the LM offense out of the end zone to make this, you know, sort of a positive going in to the half. But if LM is able to capitalize here, it will basically
three
take
wide.
All the momentum. Oh, and the snap. Lito still able to get it. Carries it outside and is pushed out eventually at the 15-yard line.
Yeah, it was three Jack wide Lane. There on the quarterback keeper. You know, interesting. I was able to watch some of the tapes from Lower Merion. I don't know if that play was designed to be
down.
A quarterback keeper, because usually they ran quarterback keepers with four wide. But, you know, three wide on that play and the quarterback keeper. Yeah, I mentioned to watch out for the three wide early on in this broadcast. There's going to be a lot of the plays won't be similar, I'll tell you that. A lot of different plays out of the three wide.
And I think the LM cheerleaders are trying to inspire a touchdown. Lito takes the snap, throws it to a wide open receiver. Number three, Kim, and he gets in for the score.
Touchdown, Lower Merion.
That'll make that four touchdowns for the Aces in just the first half alone.
Well, I'll tell you what, he had a quick out and out concept, and he was isolated into space. There was no one there for the Harriton Rams. Looked like, I don't know, that might have been zone coverage, and they didn't, weren't able to capitalize.
First time that the Harriton Rams defense has played zone this whole game, and it ends quite disastrously with a touchdown there for the Aces. And again, the kick is up and good to make this score 28-6 in favor of LM. Jason, you're Coach Miller here. You thought you had the momentum going into half, but it looks like it'll be the Aces.
Right.
What are you feeling right now? What are you saying to your guys?
Clearly something's not working. I think they do need to pass a lot more. I think the passes that they have been quick passes, quick screens. They have taken one shot downfield, which obviously resulted in an interception. I think you got
to
talk to Logan, calm him down a bit, let him know that, you know, if you don't see something, either throw it away or take it yourself. It is 28-6. They are still in this game. So we'll see if they can mount an incredible comeback.
It'll definitely be a interesting second half, although the first half is not over. Over 30 seconds. Let's see if the Rams can make something of it.
Can't call it over till it's over.
That's right. So they try to squib it, but it still goes to Molyneux. Let's see if he can make something out of this. And he can't really. He goes up the middle and is tackled at about the 26-yard line. Now, as we mentioned before, Rothberg has been struggling a bit this quarter, his only long pass resulting in an interception. And, you know, how much do you attribute that to, you know, sort of his young age? He is a sophomore right now.
Sophomore, right, yeah.
And how much do you attribute that to, you know, not the right play call?
Well, I think it was the right play call. I just don't think he was able to read the defense, you know, the way that Coach Miller probably anticipated him to. He rolled out to the right and threw to the right where that safety was, with one safety back deep. That's going to be an interception 9 times out of 10, I should say. But I think, to answer your question, I think it's probably more so of the young age rather than the play call. I think the play call is working, but his young age. He's only a sophomore, and he's the varsity quarterback.
That's right.
So
The horn sounds there. putting a cap to this second quarter and the first half. With the score being 28-6, what do you hope to see from the Rams coming out in the second half?
Well, I hope to see changes, I'll tell you that. I think they need to attack the quick passing game a little bit more. You know, they obviously, you know, we're going to moving back to last week against the Pencrest Lions. When they attacked the quick passing game on that first drive, they were able to drive down to about the 20-yard line before winding up turning the ball over. But, you know, I think you got to try to utilize maybe Matt Krebs on the outside or Seth Fleazar on the outside. You know, one of your receivers who can catch a quick slant, something you practice, something you work on in practice. Especially against this coverage, against a cover one, once your receiver gets past that corner, just let it rip. You know, fling the ball up out to your wide receivers. They can catch one of those on a quick slant. So definitely utilize the quick passing game a bit more.
And we'll see if Harriton is able to make those changes coming out in the second half. For Jason Wexler, I'm Eli Feldman. Thanks for watching HHS-TV. We'll be right back for coverage of the second half.
Sam's moderating our chat right now. There are a lot of people going on there saying some naughty things.
Wait, what did they say?
I was like,
I think towards the end I was getting better shots
than
the beginning.
That's so funny.
Yeah.
That's so
Wait,
funny.
What are they saying?
All forms of bad language. Oh, I think that they can hear us right now.
Oh.
Let's turn up. Yeah, they can hear us.
Welcome in to the HHS-TV Halftime Report. We are here live at Ferg's Field, the Ferg Dome, as many call it.
I like that name.
And if you've been joining us, you have seen LM pretty much dominate Harriton so far this game. If you haven't been joining us and you're a Harriton fan, you really haven't missed much. And, you know, really, Harriton hasn't been able to get it done through the year, hasn't been able to sustain long drives. And LM has been able to run it down Harriton's throat.
Absolutely right.
Jason, what was really the difference between these two teams in the first half?
Well, I'll tell you, that Harriton, you know, run defense really struggled against the run, especially on the outside. You know, LM utilizes an outside zone scheme where they hand the ball off to the outside and then they can cut back to the other side, sort of tire out the defense, moving them from one side to the other. We've seen that a lot. We've seen that with, like, a fullback fake. Fake to the fullback, hand to the other side. So essentially it's just been those outside runs that have really been sort of tearing apart this Rams defense. And offensively for the Rams, it's been a struggle, you know. A lot of quick screens, a lot of runs up the middle, which, you know, haven't really been working. You know, they've had blockers who have been struggling, miss a couple blocking assignments, and, you know, that's obviously allowed for loss of yards and just not the type of start that you want to a game for Coach Miller.
And if you are Coach Miller, the coach of the Rams football team, what adjustments are you making to start this second half to try to get your team back in it?
Well, I think you got to utilize something like a quick passing game, something that's quick and easy to work with, you know, getting your outside receivers involved, some of your bigger players. You know, obviously you like Teddy Molyneux. You know, he's their best guy. You know, maybe line him out wide. You know, we haven't really seen that from the scheme a lot. So, you know, just some sort of changes offensively and defensively. Those linebackers, they have to be anticipating outside zone runs. So especially those outside linebackers, seal the outside, have that middle linebacker cover. Make sure you secure the middle. So if he takes it up the middle, that you're able to make that tackle. So, yeah, hopefully we'll be seeing some adjustments here in the second half.
Speaking to some of the Rams fans, we've heard that the Harriton Rams on offense need to take more shots downfield. That's really been the sentiment of the fans,
yeah.
You know, hopefully to draw some pass interferences.
Absolutely.
And you know, it'll be interesting to see what the Rams come up with out of the second half. For all of us here at HHS-TV, this has been the Intermission Report. We'll see you back live for the start of the second half.
Welcome into the second
Welcome
half.
Welcome into the second half of the Harriton Rams taking on the Lower Merion Aces football team. If you're just joining us and you are a LM fan, it has been quite a good first half for you. The Harriton Rams seem to be going a bit up-tempo, fast pace here, giving it to Molino on second down for a loss of about one
to
make it third and long.
I'll tell you what I didn't like there. They were handing off to the outside, but pressure was coming from the outside. They had absolutely no safety in the middle of the field. You know, corners were isolated towards their receivers. I probably would have cut that up the middle there. But, again, I'm not a running back, so I can't speak for Teddy.
And the play is blown dead there. False start is the call on the Rams. That'll make it third and 14 for this already struggling offense.
Already struggling indeed. Yeah, it's been tough out there for them, hasn't it? Logan Roth, we're coming out in the field.
Speaking to some of the Rams fans during halftime, one in particular, Leo Perlstein, said that the Rams need to be more aggressive on offense. They need to take those shots downfield. Let's see if the Rams will start doing that on this third down.
Maybe we'll see Leo in the booth one day.
Oh, and Rothberg almost gets sacked there. Has to dump it off. Oh, but there seems to be a roughing the passer called.
Incomplete intended target number 11.
Yeah, I think they're going to get
flag on the play.
I think they're going to get roughing the passer there.
Roughing
that's going to be 15 yards.
It's going to be 15 yards.
Exactly right.
Automatic first down. For the Harriton Rams.
So instead of a fourth and 14, it's going to bring up a first and 10.
And so far, that has been Rothberg's best play of the game. Getting hit. That's been his best play so far. So with that penalty, that'll now bring the Harriton Rams to the LM 43.
First and 10, Rams.
First and 10.
They're going to come out with four wide and receivers playing off, lined up with the free safety.
And Rothberg keeping it himself, trying to go to the outside, gets about 3 yards.
Quarterback keeper from number 10, Logan Rothberg.
Timothy Kotev would be happy with that play.
Carries ahead for about 3 yards. Brings up second and 7.
And it's going to bring up a second and 7.
Both coaches seem to be yelling out plays to their team. The Rams, as I mentioned before, going a bit up-tempo. Rothberg takes it, gives it to Molino. The LM Aces were ready for that play, stuffing Molino before he could even get back to the line. This will bring up about a third and 9, third and 10.
I think they're going to put it on the 8. Probably put it on the 8. Give them 8 here. And, of course, the shotgun formation.
Rothberg looking, taking it himself. Not going to get it done there. Gets maybe one.
Not the start of the drive that you want.
Yeah. To bring up fourth down here. And, you know, this would be
four
down territory if I think the Rams were a little closer. But it seems as though the Rams will still be going for it as Rothberg goes back onto the field.
This is a very important play. I'm not sure what they have dialed up here, but judging by looks like
timeout.
One. Okay, they're going to call a timeout. So, you know, something I'd consider here is the safety. You know, if they have one deep safety, they're going to be in man coverage. They're going to be in cover one. I'd attack the sidelines, or I'd split the safety and the corner that the receiver is manned up against. And hopefully Rothberg has a good play up here, up his sleeve on this one, on this fourth and 7. In this 28-6 blowout.
This play certainly feels like it could absolutely set the tone for the second half. If the Rams are able to pick this up, this gives them momentum, continues the drive, and could really very easily lead to a score. If the LM Aces are able to stop them, it gives their offense good field position. It allows them to stop any momentum that Harriton possibly has, and really puts them in firm control of this game. So an important play here. And Rothberg
four wide. Looks like they're
line up in
bunch
the shotgun.
Left.
Takes it under pressure, throws, And it's caught there by number 12, Seth Blazar. And he's going to take it all the way to the house. The five, touchdown, Seth Blazar.
Okay, well, I don't want to sound, I'll tell you this, though. That is the first time Harriton has broken double digits this season. And it comes against LM, and it's the Seth Blazar. And going back to what I said at the halftime report, how do you attack this LM defense against the cover one? Quick game. Look at that. Quick slant to Seth Blazar, taking it to the distance on a touchdown. That was a nice run there.
Great throw, great catch, great all-around play, and it looks as though the Rams will be going for two here to try to get it back up to 14.
Right, make it a two-score game.
Oh, and Rothberg is going to be taken down. Teddy Molyneux could not secure the edge there and allowed his quarterback to get sacked from the blind side. As many great plays as Molyneux has shown for this Rams team. That play was absolutely, could have been prevented by a better block on Molyneux's part.
Right.
But even with that, the Rams are now down just 28-12.
Mm-hmm. It makes it a little bit more of a tougher matchup than they anticipated here coming out. As the kickoff, had they gotten the two-point conversion, would have been a two-touchdown lead for LM, making it a little more serviceable.
And the LM return team seems to be a bit confused here, but they get enough men on the field. Let's see what type of kick Harriton comes out with. And somewhat of a squib kick. And the LM Aces are just going to take it at the 30-yard line. No Harriton defender was really near him for at least 5 yards, but they still decide to just fall on it anyway.
30-yard line now, first 10 for the Lower Merion Aces. Coming out here, see how they respond after their defense just gave up a touchdown from Seth Flizar off the slant.
And again, much like in the first half when Harriton came out with a touchdown, with just a minute left, the LM Aces were able to respond very quickly. So let's see if
pressure off the
LM
right side
can continue that. But there seems to be a flag before the start of this drive. And a false start there
on the offense
will bring this to a first and 15 for the Rams, something that they like to see.
I think Seth Flizar off that play, he was coming off the edge. He was probably anticipating that run. But we'll see how LM attacks now after the penalty. They are going to come out in the same formations. Watch Flazar off the edge, off the right side.
Under center, Lido gives it to Zhang, cuts it back, tries to break free, but is still smuggled up there and by the Harriton defense. And this will bring up second and about 11 or 12.
Hand off to number 24, Jay Zhang.
If you are just joining us now or were not able to catch the first half, you missed one heck of a performance from Zhang. Jay Zhang has really been carrying this LM offense. They've given it to him, I would assume, more than half of their plays. And they go back to him here, cuts it back outside. But again, the Harriton defense seems to, pick him up a little better. I assume that's definitely something that Miller brought up to them, made sure that that was something that they stopped during halftime.
I don't think that was a run that they were expecting. I think they were probably expecting it to go right. You could see Seth Flizar anticipating that run, make sure he has leverage on the running back, shifting his squaring up over to the left side, and it went to the run. It went to the right, and he got positive yards there.
Lido lining up in the shotgun here.
They are going to come out of the 11 personnel with a three receiver set. Sometimes we might see a motion, and looks
takes
like
takes the snap, cuts it to the outside, is getting chased down by Fisher, throws it, and it's deflected by looks like number 12, Seth Blazar.
That was interesting. On the on the left hash, you're going to roll out to the right side of the field. That's a lot more time, and that allows the Harriton defense to pressure you a bit more than when you run to the left side of the field as they did to the right.
And again, as we saw in the first half, you know, the Harriton defense didn't really challenge Lito's arm much, but when they did, he wasn't really able to get it done.
Right, yeah.
So a very nice play there from the defense, making Lito beat them with his arm, which he wasn't able to do.
It's going to bring
bringing up a 4th and 9, which will make the LM Aces punt it. Molyneux receives.
Short field.
Tries to break free. Doesn't look like he's going to be able to. But gets it to the LM 48. So, again, starting off with great field position for this Harriton Rams football team. And really the momentum is for the Rams. I mean, coming out of halftime, they scored a touchdown rather quickly.
On fourth down,
scored a touchdown. Stopped the LM offense, made them go 3 and out. And now have great field position. If I'm Coach Miller, I'm looking for something aggressive here.
I'm looking on the outside.
And the give here is DeMolyneux, gaining about 3.
Hand off to number 2, Teddy Molyneux.
I think if you have man coverage all around with no safety in the middle of the field, how could you not attack the middle of the field there? You got to make sure your receiver has leverage on the corner if they're counting the drop back.
And Harriton going a little fast there.
A timeout was taken
by Lower Merion, so not a flag there, just a timeout. So, Jason, what have you seen from this Harriton Rams team so far this half?
Well, I've seen a lot of aggression, especially on offense, going for it on fourth down, enemy territory, a nice slant pattern to Seth Fleazar. And obviously they capitalize on the defensive side of the ball as well, being able to force Lower Merion to punt. And now they have the ball, looking for a touchdown here. It is 2nd and 7, and obviously a touchdown would put a lot of pressure on the Lower Merion offense to capitalize off their punt. And we'll see how they attack this type of coverage. You know, as you saw in the play before the timeout, it was full-on man coverage. And as I mentioned before, how could you not attack the middle of the field there and make sure your receiver has leverage on the corner? If they count the drop back, then definitely sort of emphasize sort of like a post route or something that would get them open in the middle of the field.
Rothberg here.
Out of the 11 personnel.
In the shotgun.
Oh,
almost an offside there. Gives it to Molyneux, trying to cut it outside. Looks like he will. Runs into his own offensive lineman.
Yeah.
But is still able to pick up the first down to the 38-yard line. And there seems to be an LM player down. Seems to be number 25, Phil Cook. A big loss for them if he's not able to return on both the offense and the defense. But hopefully he is able to return. And a nice sign of sportsmanship there as many of the Harriton players are taking a knee for their fallen brethren on the other side of the ball.
Exactly. I want to quickly shift back to that play before on the run from Molyneux. You know, they came out in the 12 personnel, one running back, two tight ends. Those two tight ends were lined up on the same side. That creates a strong side, and that creates block. And looks like he's under there, able
Phil
to get
Cook
up.
Phil Cook is walking off the field.
That's good.
With, you know, some help, but not too much. So that's definitely a good sign there. And one name that we haven't called all night is Aiden Booman Newman. He's been outside for the Rams to the left basically this whole game and has had 0 targets, even though he's gotten a lot of man-to-man.
Well, now Aiden, absolutely.
He's a big body, right? He's 6 foot, but yet there just hasn't been enough aggressive play calling in the passing game to really get him the ball. So we'll see what the Rams will do here. Rothberg takes the snap. And Molyneux evading tacklers.
He's fast. He's quick.
He's at the 10. He's at the 5. He'll be tackled at the 4-yard line.
Look at that. How about that? Right at the second half, they look like a completely new team. utilizing Molino, utilizing Flazar, those wide Gain receivers, as you said, haven't really seen much of Boomin Aiden Newman.
And look at this. The Harriton Rams are going fast-paced, no huddle.
Haven't seen that a lot. And it
giving
is out
it
of
to
the
Molino,
gun.
Trying to bounce it outside. Looks like he's not going to be able to do much there. But he was still able to get back to about the line of scrimmage, which on that play,
is
a positive.
Just like to give a special shout-out to one of our very own, Noah Zeller. He couldn't be with us today as he was stuck studying for the SATs.
He was not happy about it as he was questioning whether those are still going to be happening right now. That's
right, yeah.
Sort of up in the air.
Well, I'm signed up to take mine in March.
I am signed up to take one in December, taking the ACT.
Oh, yeah?
And we'll get back to that in a little bit. But the Rams here line up four wide receivers
and
with Rothberg in the
linebackers crowding the line.
Looks for anybody. Fines.
He had Molina.
Let's see. Looks like number 11, Matt Krebs.
He had Molina open in the flat. Probably could have been a quick strike touchdown there. But obviously, Logan Rothberg not able to identify that. And it's going to bring up third down.
Third and six here. I assume that even if the Rams don't punch it in here, that they will still be going for it on fourth down, which is why it might be wise to go for a run here. You know, you have two downs. And the pitch is to Molino. He throws it. Oh! And the wide receiver is not able to catch it.
Passing. Oh, well, I like the aggression.
Flazar. I like the play call there. Everyone was expecting it to go to Molino.
Right.
The
especially after
tight
last
end,
play.
Flazar, wide open, yet just not a great throw from Molino and just not able to catch it from Flazar. You know, really a great opportunity there.
It's going to bring up a fourth down.
Fourth down here.
Wouldn't it be
six,
a shame if they couldn't capitalize off that?
With all the momentum that they had, first and five.
Look at those corners head on. They are pressing up. They are forcing. He's going to force him inside. Watch the leverage on the out. Yep, see them going inside?
Oh, and it's knocked down there by the LM defense.
Pass from Logan Rothberg, incomplete.
Yeah, that's a shame. I think if you're Coach Meller, I think you got to be pretty happy with what your offense just put together there, especially that coming out
20,
after the touchdown. I'm sure they would have loved a score. But, hey, listen, they marched down the field. They were gifted pretty good field position from Molino's return. You know, obviously a shame that they couldn't capitalize, but I think you got to be pretty proud with what you established there.
I think Meller would have been a lot happier with the points.
It is first and 10 for Lower
Merion. His team really could have used it, still down two scores. But it does give the defense pretty good field position with the LM offense starting at their own six. Lito taking the snap. Oh, and it's high. It's going to go out of the back of the end zone.
They're going to mark that a
safety.
Wow,
that's
well. That gives
surprising.
Them that gives them the 2 points. They lost off the 2-point conversion and the ball back.
Wow, that in a sudden turn of events, the Harriton Rams are down just 14 with the ball back, getting it at 4 minutes 20 seconds left
right.
In this third quarter.
The thing about safeties is, whenever a team scores a safety, the scoreboard always looks very weird, right? Like sometimes it's like 5-3 or 10-5.
Of course.
But in this case, that safety makes it a two touchdown lead for
the
Harriton.
Crazy score.
The crazy score
of
28-14 here. It's definitely great now for Harriton, and they're going to be gifted the ball back as safety works. Or they could have done a 12-point safety as Owen Lester, the very great Owen Lester. Has
and
inquired about adding into the football.
Number six, Jeremiah.
For now, it's just counting for two. And normally, the kick would be from the own 40, but now it's from kicking team's 20.
I think, not sure about how it works in high school, but in college, they do free kicks from the punter. They just kick off, like drop as they would. And, okay, no, not in high school, I guess. I guess they don't do that
still
in high school.
Still, though, this should amount to great field position for the Rams. Let's see where they can get it. LM kicks off. Pretty high kick.
Upman takes it up.
Rams trying to go for the sideline there. With a stiff arm. Gets to the... Oh! And
number
seems
seven,
to be a little
Fisher
extracurricular activities. Number 20
flag
there on
the
LM.
I like
Aces.
The extracurricular activities.
Looks like Deshaun Jemison is going to cost his team another 15 yards, which should give the Rams even better field position.
You know, this is an extracurricular activity, football.
An extracurricular at an extracurricular. Good point, Jason.
Now it is going to bring up Harrison's ball now off the 15-yard penalty.
The refs are still discussing, so it's not set in stone yet. Let's see if they make it official.
And it is against that Lower Merion.
Personal foul against Lower Merion.
So some unnecessary roughness there. So the Rams, you know, you thought that they were going to have great field position starting at about the LM 45.
Yeah,
no, they're going to have even better field position starting at the LM 29.
Yep. Now they have a chance to make it a one touchdown deficit
with
for Harriton.
You know, we thought that the momentum was going to shift back to LM after Harriton was not able to punch it in. But
it's just been a completely
so
different
far,
half.
This quarter has been all Harriton the whole time.
Motion and number eight. He is going to make sure he seals that tight end.
Rothberg takes the snap, gives to Molyneux. Wrong choice there.
Number two, Teddy Molyneux.
The LM Aces were ready for it. Number 25, Phil Cook, back in the game. It's good to see him back as he was injured.
Right, yeah. Good to see him back on the field.
And it's good to see him there. Not so great to see him tackling Teddy Molyneux, but, you know, still good to see him.
Unless
you're an LM fan.
LM fan.
So
as many may be watching this
that's
broadcast.
That's true. It's being broadcast to both schools.
They come out with two wide.
Here.
And a motion.
Flazar motioning.
Another.
Rothberg,
yep, they're anticipating that right side.
And there seems to be a false start here.
Well, I'll tell you what they were about to do. They were about to throw
on the offense.
To the right or to the
5 yard penalty.
To the right side of the field. Because they motion to the left, and that draws the attention of the defense to the left, as it would in man coverage. And then they went to do a quick strike to four, I believe, Aiden Newman, off the go route, it looked like.
Aiden Boomin Newman.
Boomin Newman. Boomin Newman.
To
Boomin.
Get the catch there because of the penalty. That'll bring up a second and 21 for the Rams. It'll be very hard for the team to overcome, you know, this sort of bad field position in just really two plays.
They're going to come out 10 personnel, four receiver set, another motion. Let's see if they attack the right side here because of the motion.
Rothberg,
yep,
looking
going right.
Under pressure, tries to get it to Molyneux, who was about to have a
pass
big hole. But
incomplete.
Rothberg under pressure, not
Ten
able target, to get it to Molyneux.
Two,
that's
Molyneux.
A play
I like
that certainly showed his sort of newerness to the game,
mm-hmm.
sort of
right.
his inexperience. If you put, you know, maybe a senior quarterback in that situation who, you know, maybe a little taller,
right,
might
right,
be able
right.
to see over the defense.
Maybe someone like the backup quarterback, Matthew Vonderhyde.
Matthew Vonderhyde, the backup quarterback for this Rams team, stands at about 6'1",
mm-hmm.
might have been able to mm-hmm. see over the defense there. But still with 3rd and 21 here, the Rams will presumably
although I do
be
like
looking to pass.
I do really like how Logan Rothberg has been handling the situation right now. Especially the second half. He's got a passing touchdown, but just been quick strike ability. I'm proud.
That's true. Rothberg takes the snap, has time, fires.
Good throw.
He completes there to number 11, Matt Krebs. Still, though,
like
even with that gain, that'll bring up about a 4th and 10, maybe 11. It looks, though, that the Harriton Rams are not interested in punting.
For the Rams.
They
or
are,
kicking.
Or kicking. In fact, we haven't seen a field goal attempt or an extra point attempt all game for the Rams. So They are going to be going for it here.
Four wide. I think they probably, yep.
Rothberg takes the snap, whistles before, now, and looks to be a timeout from Coach Meller, like, wanting to make sure that he has the right play call for this very important play. And, you know, a wise move there to make sure that he has everything that he wants ready to go for this play.
I think, you know, obviously we were doing the game last Friday against Pencrest right here on this field, and something you mentioned about the Harriton defense was that how they're really struggling able to pick up the motions, especially against a team that plays a lot of man coverage. When you're in man coverage, you have to pick up the motions. Lower Merion has done a pretty good job picking up the motions defensively. You know, this is a team that comes out in man coverage a lot. You know, they've motioned Seth Flizar over to the left side a couple times, then come back to the right. It's a good job from Lower Merion being able to pick up the motions, and a really good job from Harriton being able to notice that they're picking up the motions and attack the side that they were on before, which is how you which is how they got that gain right there on third down, or the one before that, I should say.
The Rams come back out with four wide receivers. Rothberg in the shotgun, as he is
done. Pressure off the
Rothberg under pressure still. Oh, trying to find his receiver, Matt Krebs, but the ball looked
Pass
like it was deflected by number 25
number
for
11,
LM,
Matt
Phil
Krebs.
Cook.
Boom and
Tough
Newman.
Break there for the Harriton Rams offense, as they were not able to convert, but do give their defense somewhat good field position
is first and 10, at Lower Merion, the 29
LM 29. It would be pretty surprising if we had a repeat of what happened last drive for the Aces.
Yeah.
I'm sure that their center has had a good talking to by their coaches.
Yeah, this is an offense that plays a lot under center rather than shotgun, and usually when they do that, they run the ball.
That's right.
And we'll see what they come out with here.
Lito under center.
There's the fake to the fullback.
Forces him outside. And
hand off to number 24, Jay Zeng.
Gets about only two on that play, two or three.
Gain of three on the play.
And that'll bring up a second and seven. So,
right, yeah.
I'm sure a little more than what they could have given up, but still pretty good.
Yeah, I think Harriton really putting emphasis on the Harriton defense, especially that linebacking core, to seal the C gap off the edge, especially. They've done a nice job in the second half stopping the outside run. And then it looks like LM's going to come out with five wide.
Five wide.
Two to the left, three to the right. It's an empty set, and they are going to motion.
And Lito takes it himself, cuts it outside. And there are two flags on the play. He did pick up the first down, but it is likely that this is going to be called back.
This is why zone coverage is so important, because when you motion against man coverage, you're taking away one of the man from the other side of the field. So the side that just got motioned against, that side is going to be wide open. And essentially, against a five wide like this, where you have two receivers, that side that motions, you're going to have one receiver now, and that's going to be open grass if that corner is able to be sealed. And is holding on the offense.
And
that's
it will
back.
Be holding against the Aces.
I think zone coverage.
Which will bring up about a second and 15.
10-yard penalty brings up second and 17 for
17.
The Aces.
Second and 17.
Right. I think, playing man is, you know, it's simple to teach to high school students. You know, zone coverage a little more complicated. So I understand the story behind that.
Lito under center again.
Another offset two receiver set.
Offset,
definitely anticipating.
And takes the snap. Gives to number 17 there. Let's see. 17, Raheem Abdul Salam.
Hand off to number 17, Ben Booker.
And an interesting deviation from the Jay Zeng show.
You know, this is I think Harriton, obviously we've seen a lot of Jay Zeng, and we've seen a lot of, in the second half, it's sort of been a different show for offensively. They're kind of getting everyone involved now. We haven't really seen a lot of Zhang here in the second half. Harriton defense is used to going up against teams that are sort of from committee, like against Pencrest last year or
and
last week.
LM tosses out wide there, and two,
pass
number
Plato,
three,
complete.
Lance Kim.
To number three, Lance
but
Kim.
They will still be a few yards short of the first. Some
fourth
interesting
I
coverage,
think,
you could say, from the Rams.
Right,
as
yeah.
No one
so
was near Kim,
game,
even after he had gone 5-7 yards
uh-huh.
down from
well,
the line of scrimmage.
Here they're about to go for it. Looks. Oh, no, it looks like they're going to – what are they going to punt?
They are bringing out their punting team.
I'm
so
a little surprised
like
here.
So it looks like is going to go back to receive for the Rams.
I think, you know, I think they could have –
fourth
possibly
and two,
outside
definitely
zone.
Could have gone for it.
Right, especially since that outside run has really been a strong suit for this LM offense. A little surprising that they're not going for it.
Nobody really rushing there for the Rams. And
good thing Mono did not touch that. That could have been a muffed punt.
And great that punt there for
the
LM Aces. That will leave the Harriton Rams at the at their own 22-yard line with just 54 seconds left
right.
in the third, down by two
well,
touchdowns.
Well, I think you got to be proud of what this offense has been able to put together. You know, capitalizing from the touchdown, they got the safety on defense. They were able to drive down the field. Eventually turned it over on downs, which led to the safety. You know, I think if you're Coach Mel, you're relatively proud of what your offense is putting together, especially this season. They've been struggling a lot. So, yeah, first time they've broken 10 all season.
Over 10 points for the Rams.
Double digits, as
double
you may
digits.
Say.
Very nice. It's a good accomplishment for them. And they throw it out wide here for about 4 yards.
Logan Rothberg complete to number 11, Matt Krebs.
Matt Krebs there with the reception. So with just about 40 seconds left in this
gain
third
four
quarter.
Gain of 4 on the play brings up 2nd and 6.
The Rams are going up pace here, so they will get
right.
at least one more play in.
With 31
Rothberg
seconds, this will probably
takes
be the
snap
last play.
And gives it to Molyneux, who gains about 1 yard on that play. And now about 20 seconds left. It looks like the Rams are, you know, also are going to try to squeeze in another play. No, they look
no
to be.
No gain on the play brings up 3rd and 6.
Well, you got 6 seconds left. I think you just got to let the quarter run out here. I think if you're Coach Miller, you're going to want to talk to your team. You're going to need to score 2 touchdowns here in the fourth quarter.
I think
that would tie
quarter.
The game. So
score at the end of 3 quarters of play.
And
Lower
the score at
they
the
have
end of
back.
3 quarters is LM 28, Harriton 14.
14.
Now, that play call to let the clock run out on that play, very reminiscent of a different play call
last week
when the Harriton Rams were playing Pencrest. They were down 7-0. On their own 5-yard line with
first
time
quarter.
Running down in the first quarter. So, of course, they were going to get the ball back, you know, to start the second quarter. They decide to hurry up and rush. That results in a pick to end the quarter. And I'm sure that, you know, that haunted Meller,
right.
all week. So the wise choice there to just not do anything there and try to start the fourth quarter off with a first down conversion.
Yeah, I agree with you. You're absolutely right. Now, I think, you know, after each quarter, you switch sides. I think that's part of it.
That is
maybe they like the parking lot side better rather than that side.
As the Molyneux score came towards I'm not sure what side you would call that, but the farther side. And Rothberg takes the snap, looking downfield.
Almost
trips. It's going to be, oh, almost picked off again there.
You know,
I
think the rolling out is very interesting in this sense. You're allowing your core, obviously, he's a mobile quarterback. He can, you know, make something happen with his legs. He likes to dance around in the pocket. I think
and
obviously, you know, obviously you don't want to throw across the field when you roll out, but I think you got to throw it a little sooner than that. If you want to do a naked bootleg, that's something that they could utilize, sort of like a play action and then a bootleg around the side. We don't really see play action in this offense, but.
And there was a flag there.
Ineligible man downfield.
It
that
was
an
ineligible man downfield. The call there from LM to decline, bringing up a fourth down there.
Right. And looks like they are going to punt.
Looks like the Rams are going to punt. One of the very few times this game that the Rams are going to punt. Takes the snap.
Oh, it's blocked.
And
now they're going to get good field position on that one.
And it will be the LM Aces with field with the ball at the 12-yard line.
I don't think
line.
Punts usually go backwards, so I think that was definitely blocked.
The Aces fall on the ball
at
15 yards.
So I would be quite surprised if it wasn't blocked.
First and 10 for Lower Merion.
Just saying.
And with this first and 10 with great field position, it would really be a testament to this Harriton Rams defense if they were able to stop them.
Right.
You know, maybe hold them to a field goal or, you know, maybe force them to go for it on a fourth down later on. But the give here is to Zhang with a big hole, and he's going to power in there for a touchdown.
Hand off to number 24, Jay Zhang.
Bringing the score to 34
for a Lower Merion touchdown.
With the extra point soon coming.
Yeah, that was right up the middle against the interior of the Rams' defensive line, which has struggled in the past. Obviously, they've given up the most rushing yards, which dates all the way back to the first week of the season against Marple Newtown, where they gave up 200 rushing yards and four touchdowns on the ground to that crazy duo of Charlie Box and Brian Jocelyn for Marple Newtown. And again, reminiscent of that.
And the kick is good, but there is a flag on the play.
Flag on the play.
Additionally, the Harriton Rams boys soccer team has also walked out onto the track. They're on the opposite side of the field. I believe that they have a practice tonight.
I'm not sure,
you know, what they're thinking. There is a football game.
Dead ball penalty, encroachment against Harriton.
And the penalty is against Harriton for encroachment. And seems as though
they will replay the try.
Oh, okay.
They're going to be redoing the
extra point. Well, that I'll tell you, that touchdown is a big statement touchdown. Extra point would make it 35-14. Here in the fourth quarter, pretty much diminishes the Rams' chances of making a fourth quarter comeback. Hey, I mean, never call it's over till it's over. You know, we saw what happened in Atlanta with the Cowboys in that game. So.
And the extra point attempt is good.
With the extra point made.
This kicker has not missed one today.
That is true. The LM kicker is 5-for-5. That brings the score to LM 35, Rams 14. So the Rams are now down 21 points in the fourth quarter. If you are just joining us, the way that this game has gone, it was all LM first half. They went into the half up 21-6, I believe. Third quarter, all Rams.
They
got a touchdown.
Safety.
To return the kick.
Good drives throughout the quarter.
And six,
fourth
Jeremiah
quarter,
Patterson.
Just a few minutes into it, and it's been all LM so far.
Well, I think it's safe to say that the Rams are a third quarter team this season. Throughout the whole season, all of their scoring is, you know, relatively come in the third quarter. They've entered the half with most of the times a zero on the scoreboard. And then in the games that they have scored, there have been some where they have not scored. It came in the third quarter for the most part, sometimes fourth.
LM with the kick there. And the Rams are going to take it to about their own 33-yard line. So starting
ball
off
has
with
returned out to the 33
pretty good
yard
field
line.
Position there.
First and 10, Harriton.
You know, it's crazy. It's only 6:30, and it feels like it's 9.
That is true. The moon is out. I believe it is waning. It could very easily be waxing. I am sorry, Miss Crater, my second grade teacher.
Oh, I never asked you. How did your mock trial meeting go?
My mock trial meeting went pretty well. Back to the game. Rothberg.
Another motion here
from
Krebs.
Shotgun there. Gives it to Molyneux.
Yep.
The line just decimated around him.
I think
nowhere to go for
him. It's definitely a good play. It's a good play. They're in man coverage. If you motion Matt Krebs to the other side, you're essentially eliminating the left side of the field from any LM defender. But if the defensive line can manage to get to the running back before the linebackers in the corners, that's going to result in a loss of yards, as we saw there. But if he took that outside, that could have been probably a 10-yard gain. But I like the play call.
With the 2nd and 14 here and Rothberg lining up in the shotgun formation, it'll be interesting to see if Coach Miller calls up, sort of an aggressive play call here with Krebs motioning. And
good pass.
The give there is to Molyneux. Has some room, but again, the LM defender swarming him. So a lot
Rothberg
of... Oh, and there is a flag
Molyneux
coming in.
There's really been a lot of flags for both teams.
It did come very late, so it seems like it will be a roughing the passer. And it is against number 9.
Yeah,
it looks to be. And the LM coach is not happy with number 9 because he knew that it would have, if without the penalty, it would have been, a good spot for that defense. But with the penalty, it gives the Rams new life, a first down, and... I mean, Coach Joe Augustine
it
is
almost
not
seemed
happy with that.
That prior to the start of the second half, the Rams' yards have come off of penalties from the LM defense,
for the Rams.
And it carries over now.
Certainly does help. So, as we saw with that last one and throughout the game, there have been a lot of screens to Molyneux to
and
try to get this offense
this is
out.
a 21 personnel,
Rothberg,
two tight ends.
Moving out, tries to take a deep shot.
Double
no
coverage.
One there. Krebs had to defend the defenders to make sure that they did not catch the ball there.
He was being covered by both the free safety and the corner, so it's going to be a tough catch either way. So at that point, if you know that you don't have leverage on the corner, you got to play defense. Knock it down, especially if you're a receiver. And, obviously, this is high school football. These guys play both offense and defense, so it's not like they're playing out of position in that sense.
And that was a nice play by Krebs there to make sure the ball was not picked off. And Rothberg, he wasn't under pressure there. He was able to get a good throw off. And it was nice to see the aggressiveness, but the accuracy was not there. Now with this play, Flazar motioning.
Look at that.
Rothberg
the left side is completely, yep, there you go, left side.
Molyneux taken down there. And he seemed to cough up the ball, but it was out of bounds before anyone could get to it. That brings up a 3rd and 7 here.
It doesn't look like it doesn't look like LM was able to pick up that motion. I mean, they did make the tackle. He did gain a few yards, it's simple. Motion to the right, hand off to the left. That's how it works.
And the give there is to Molyneux, going nowhere with that play. The line was not able to hold off the defenders. It just was not there for the Rams. And now with, a fourth and about 15, it's looking like the Rams will have to punt.
They should hand off to Zhang. He's on my fantasy team.
Thought about picking up Zhang, but, I just couldn't.
He's no. Interesting. He was on the waiver wire for a few weeks now. Just saying.
Oh, and another interesting punt there.
Another flag there.
Yeah, another one.
This one might go against the Rams for unnecessary roughness. Might go against number 20, Elijah Peterson.
First time we've heard his name tonight.
That ball, a personal foul against Harriton.
And just like it really helped the Rams with the last penalty when it was against LM, so too will this penalty against the Rams really help LM.
Right.
I mean, you know, great field position in the Rams' territory before they start their drive. And with under 9 minutes left, if the LM Aces are able to sustain a long drive here, it will almost certainly put a
sort of right the ship
stamp on this envelope of a and game. I don't think that's an expression, but I made it up.
It would be a tough loss. Would be a tough loss for the Rams. I mean, we're not calling it over
that
until
is correct.
It's over.
All that the Rams need to do is get a stop here.
And
you know,
they also need
turnover.
To stop the offset eye run to the right.
And the give here again
or left.
is to Zhang. He cuts it out. He's at the 10. He's at the 5. They take him down at the 1 yard line. So
number 24, Jay Zhang.
Definitely a statement run right there. You're
definitely
in the offset
a statement
eye.
Run. Definitely a statement
line.
That said, no one
first
is going
goal,
to stop me.
No one can
I
stop me.
I am Jay Zhang.
Yeah.
And I
the
mean,
greatest running back to ever lace him up.
For the LM Aces, possibly. And, I mean, that's just a devastating run there for the Rams.
I think the first play
of their drive, and now it's first and one to go.
Under center again,
under
two
center,
receiver set. Looks like a quarterback
Lido
sneak.
Sneaks it in for his third
touchdown.
Count him. One, two, three. Three rushing touchdowns of the game to put the LM Aces up 41-14.
Let me find the hat. Where's the hat? There's the hat. Hat trick.
Hat
throw
trick.
Your hats in the stands.
To the extra point,
hat trick
27, Sean
for the LM Aces. You know, if I could, I would. Yeah, you know, I'm sure you would too. It is a cold night, but in you
I
know
need my
spirit.
Hat.
I'm not even wearing mine, but. Let's pretend I threw my hat out into the crowd.
And the kick is good for LM. That makes it a perfect 6-for-6 for the LM kicker. I also considered picking him up off the waiver wire.
That would be 6 points. I mean, I do have Youngway Koo, so I think I'm okay at the kicker position. But, you know, not a bad.
That's right.
Kicker right here.
With that extra point, that brings the score to 42-14. If I'm doing my math correctly, that puts the Aces up 28 points. And, I mean...
I think you're doing it correctly.
Thank you. 28 points with just about 8.5 minutes left. Very tough for the Rams. They're going to have to pull out their deepest plays in their playbook, the bag of tricks.
Yeah, I mean, with 8 minutes left, I think it's possible.
You know,
I'm optimistic.
Now is not the time to be calling, you know, the short little runs, you know, the pitches. It now is the time for the Rams to be aggressive, to try to make something out
I think,
these last couple of
I
minutes.
Think, you know, letting Logan drop back is definitely something they could do. You know, we don't really see that a lot. Usually when they pass, it's either quick screen or rollout, and rollouts have resulted in interceptions.
And the Rams there going through a couple of
return
tackles
on the play
there,
by number 6, Jeremiah Patterson.
And the Rams will get it at about their own 35-yard line.
Takes it out to around the 35-yard line.
Yeah, we really haven't seen much since that third quarter. Their last score, if you're just tuning in, 14-42. Don't be deceived. Their last score was a safety. And, you know, they had 12 on the board. Safety makes it 14, so they did not score two touchdowns to make it 14. They did have a safety.
They did score two touchdowns.
They did score two
14.
Touchdowns, but that, yeah, right.
Anyway.
They missed on the two, and then they got the safety.
Anyway, Rothberg pitches it to Molino. Krebs trying to give a block there, but again, another flag there. I think the hit was
pitch
a bit too
Teddy
high.
Molino.
That's going to be another 10
get
or 15
you're probably
going to
get unnecessary roughness here.
And, I mean, for how...
tackled out of bounds at the 37-yard line.
Tame might not be the right word, but really, for how tame these two football teams are, the number of unnecessary roughnesses
personal foul,
in
face
this
mask,
game.
Against Lower Merion.
And the play is not unnecessary.
Well,
roughness,
even if, well, I'll tell you what, face mask and unnecessary roughness, you know, they're both 15-yard penalties. They're both, they've both
essentially
been
the same.
Right.
Penalty.
So I'd say this. I think it goes a little bit between some, you know, they're rivals. So you got some, you know, the blood isn't necessarily that, you know, good. It's very bad blood between these two teams. So you're probably going to want to play a little harder. They're going to come out in nickel now, defensively. Three corners in the game. Oh, no, I'm sorry.
Rothberg,
there's one safety. So
takes the snap. Gives to Molino. Molino going nowhere with it. Loses about one on the play.
Hand off to Teddy Molino on the play.
Absolutely and nowhere on that play finished. Right there. We've only seen Rothberg pass about nine times.
Second and 11.
Which definitely isn't a lot, and it's especially when you're down 14-42, you know, you're going to want to pass more to come back in the game. They haven't really entered enemy territory off of offensive drives. The only times they've entered enemy territory has really been when they've been gifted the ball in enemy territory from Molino's returning. So we'll see if they can approach deeper.
And a flag there to stop the
play
before it can begin. And a
false start
there
against Harriton.
Against the Rams to make it
second and
16.
Right.
So, again, not great field position. But, again, going back to your point of the Rams needing to throw it more, basically, of the few throws that we've seen, at least of the incompletions, they've mostly been, you know, Rothberg trying to do it all himself on go routes to the outside.
Go routes, yeah.
That is not what the Rams need right now because they mostly do not work.
I'll tell you what, we saw one successful play, and it was a slant, and it ended in a touchdown. So
and
another try on the screen and
the ball
in the flat.
Batted down there by number 20, Deshaun Jemison of the LM Aces.
Deshaun Jemison.
Well, you know, back to what I was saying before, they have had one play that has really worked, and that's been the quick screen. And I said during our halftime report, the way that they can attack this LM defense, the cover one heavy man coverage, is with the quick slant game. They have done it once, and it resulted in a touchdown. Haven't really seen it since then. They've really been trying to pound the rock with the running game, and it just has not been working.
Rothberg takes the snap, looks long, gets hit as he throws, so he's not going to be able
another
to get it there.
Another flag.
Another flag
this one comes,
coming in.
This one comes in the secondary.
Number 4, Aiden Newman. Flag on the play.
Trying to get it to number 4, Aiden Boomin Newman.
Boomin Newman is what they call him. I like that nickname.
If you took the over on number of times, we would say, Boomin Newman, you're going home happy tonight.
Yes, sir. I also, you know, so my score prediction wasn't that off either.
And what's a little surprising is this LM team came into this game 0-4
right.
And did not – I mean, I have not looked
holding
at the
–
you know, what their total scores for all the games have added up to. I assume that it has not added up to 42.
It hasn't. I'll tell you what, though. Their most points is 24 in one game, and they have already eclipsed over 40 points in this game. Everyone's taking a knee here. Is there an injury timeout or something?
Seems to be the refs just getting in sync with each other.
Anyways, yes, they have eclipsed over 40 points in this game. Their season high was 42 or 24.
Rothberg under pressure there, trying to find Molino, but he just can't
another
connect.
Another flag in the secondary.
And another flag.
And it's in the secondary once again.
Flag on the play.
Yeah, definitely interesting
so
here.
So many flags.
Well, I definitely did not expect this many flags. You know, going into this game, if you asked me what the most common penalty would be, I probably would be saying unnecessary roughness, just because it's Lower Merion Harriton rivals. They want to hit harder. But, yeah, definitely not this many. We've seen face masks. We've seen unnecessary roughnesses. We've seen false starts. I know someone who really loves the false start penalty. It is my uncle. So, loves the false start. So, maybe he's happy watching some false starts.
The penalty here, not false start, but something
against not false start here, but like in the
Rams. Possibly holding. So this will bring up a 3rd and 16 for the Rams.
After that 10-yard penalty,
it feels as though the drive has been going on forever, but it has
for
not.
Rams.
Just been all the penalties. So now.
Yeah, I mean, this is the fourth quarter where wins become losses and losses become wins.
Very, very true. Rothberg in the shotgun here calls like for motion for Krebs. Krebs.
I think, yep, got to attack the left side.
And Molino there with the catch, trying to break through to get something there. And he does break a couple of tackles, but
pretty much they were really confused that LM defense, because what he did was he motioned Matt Krebs. So the LM defense immediately says, okay, they're motioning Matt Krebs. We got to watch the left side because there's absolutely no one there. So linebackers, you better shift over to the left side. Then what they do is Rothberg rolled out to the right side. So then they said, oh, is he throwing to the right side? Because whenever he rolls out, he goes to the right side. Then he throws it across the field to the left side. And look at that, he got a completion. So that's pretty much what just happened on that play. Confusing the LM defense. Now watch pressure off the
fourth
left side.
Fourth down, the Rams going for it. Rothberg stepping up, passing it. Oh, and it's incomplete to number 11, Matt Krebs. And with that incompletion, that'll be a turnover on downs for the Rams, which will give the LM Aces the ball. First and 10 for LM at their own about 46-yard line.
Right. Yeah, definitely got to – probably going to see not a lot of their workhorse running back again, because, you know, it's going to be a little bit out of a committee here, up 42-14 in the fourth quarter, late in the fourth quarter. I said, say, approaching the mid-mark of the fourth quarter. They're only 12 minutes in high school. But, yeah, so as a Harriton run defense, a lot of emphasis on them to be able to stop the run and – seal those gaps so they can disrupt their running game that they want to establish.
And with the LM Aces up 28 at this point in the game, you know, a little over 6.5 minutes left, you gotta assume that they're gonna be running the ball a whole lot to their workhorse back, Jay Zhang. And
it's a bunch to the right. Another flag.
Delay of game on the offense.
Looks like they didn't get the playoff
and
or the playoff in time.
If you look at this, the LM offense with the score being what it is right now, they don't have Lito as their quarterback right now. They have number 11, A.J. Haynes,
I want to be honest,
a senior.
This is the first time I've seen a high school team do this, and I've called about four different games counting this one, and all of them, they've been blowouts, but they have kept their quarterbacks in the entire game.
And the give there is to – oh, and another penalty.
This
what?
Has got to be some
That's
kind of record.
That's so surprising. J.K., no, it is not.
Jake.
Number 17, Ben Booker up the middle.
And obviously we're not seeing a lot of Jay Zhang anymore. We're seeing Ben Booker.
Number 17, Ben Booker. Right. You want to know a little fun story about Ben Booker?
Oh, you know?
I do, in fact, know Ben Booker. He's a freshman for LM. He and I worked at the same camp this summer.
Did you?
We did, in fact,
Wait,
work
let me
at
guess. What was it? Arrowhead.
Camp Arrowhead, a little free publicity right there.
Right, right.
And we both worked there. And, you know, when we would play football, I would be way better than him. So, you know,
What is this? Are you going to your playing days?
I mean,
you're gonna
the Harriton Rams
didn't you hang
them
up?
Right.
Didn't you hang them up a couple years ago? You going back to your playing days now? All right.
I might have to lace him back up.
All right.
If the Rams need me, I'll be there. Anyway,
maybe you can help this offset I run.
With Haynes giving it to Booker there. He is pushing through for a couple on that play.
Ben Booker.
And things are getting a little chippy here. Really, I think everyone, you know, wants this game to go a little quicker. I think everyone's sort of sick of the penalties.
And
it's
the cold.
Very cold out.
Gain of 5 on the play.
Right. No one really wants this game to continue. So getting
second,
chippier
right
now
right.
is not what the doctor ordered.
Right. Yeah. Couldn't have said it any better. Good job. And it is 2nd and 20. As we approach the 5:10 mark of the fourth quarter in an absolute dominating lead for the Lower Merion Aces.
Also, in 5 minutes, the NBA draft. I hope the game can
end
with enough time.
Who do you think's going number one?
Number one, my
pick. You got LaMelo Ball. You got Edwards.
Okay, well, first there's a timeout for Lower Marion, so it'll give us a little time.
Give us a little time to talk about some basketball.
Write it down right here, folks. Right. Number one overall
Anthony
pick.
Edwards.
Anthony Edwards.
I can agree.
Out of Georgia.
I agree with you, Eli.
It is not so much that he is the consensus best talent. It's really that all of the other players have sort of taken themselves
out of
contention. You know, the big three going into this draft were
LaMelo Ball.
LaMelo Ball.
Yeah, Edwards.
You know, of course, of the great Ball family.
Absolutely.
You know, James Wiseman, the big center coming out of Memphis. And Edwards.
Right.
And
I've always been high on Anthony Edwards as well.
If you look at the Minnesota Timberwolves, who own the number one overall pick, you'll see that they already have Karl Anthony Towns, so that really fills their center position. And, you know, they haven't liked LaMelo Ball's character, so I'm going with Edwards as the number one overall pick. And in the game now, number 11,
set.
Haynes
off
takes
coverage
the snap.
From the outside. Yep, they're going to go right to the off.
Throws to number 8, Andre Gilmore. Breaks a couple of tackles, is still in bounds. He's still going, folks.
That was a opposite curls concept. They're gonna take your slot receivers, put them deep, eliminate the deep safety. The deep safety, put that in quotes because they didn't really have a deep safety. But then your slot receiver, your outside receivers are gonna be your curl route concept, off coverage on them, and pick up the first down there on a nice play. Or not first down. Or
and it looks like this
down.
Play is going to be called back because you guessed it.
Another penalty. That's going to push it back
we
there.
We have not been keeping track so far of the penalties. I wish we had because really this is getting a little crazy.
Right.
Refs, the game is 42-14.
Sometimes you just got to let them play.
That is correct. And
unless you see something so obvious. Like you don't want to make any bad calls. Right.
I mean, LM has pulled their starting quarterback, and, you know, you're still calling penalties. But it's your choice. You're the refs. Haynes takes the snap, throws it deep to number 14, Declan Mack, a freshman, not able to complete it there. But Haynes
showing off the arm. Mack from the slot, he's pretty much just going to run a quick corner. Like he's going to get about 10 yards upfield and then cut against that coverage. You're going to be able to split the safety or split the corner and the safety. And that's basically finding a soft spot and in man. I mean, there's not really soft spots in man, but, you know, it was a nice play there as they have been able to attack the deep third of the field on that play. And they didn't pull it down, but definitely a good decision there.
This will bring up 3rd and 20.
Watch pressure off the left.
The give here is to Booker. Trying to get anything, and the pile does move forward.
Hand off up the middle to number 17, Ben Booker.
Pressure off the left.
About 3 yards
to the
there,
right.
But this will still bring up a 4th and long, which will bring out the LM punting team.
Well, there you go. Some signs of life. Maybe they can put up an extra score or two before we head on out of here.
And back to receive for the Rams is, as always, number 2, Teddy Molyneux. Whenever the Rams need someone for a skilled position, you know, really involving the ball, they look to senior Teddy Molyneux.
And
another penalty.
In the middle of this penalty, I'd just like to say I kind of consider Teddy Molyneux as the Swiss Army knife of this offense and defense, as he can sort of play any position, you know.
And special teams.
Special teams as well, right? Yeah, he's just like Taysom Hill with the New Orleans Saints. He also plays special teams. I consider him a Swiss Army knife. He's a hybrid player. He can play receiver. He can play linebacker, and he can play kick returner. So definitely an athletic individual that Harriton has on the field in his senior year, as he looks to take his talents elsewhere.
Oh, and almost blocked there. I don't think it was. I just think that it wasn't a great punt there.
Punt
so
the
Harriton Rams will start at their own 45, so great field position here. just over 3 minutes left. Let's see if the Rams and Coach Miller can come up with a nice drive here to, you know, possibly get one more score on the board to show that this one was, you know, maybe not as competitive as they would have liked, but right. still competitive enough. And, you know, will make the Rams go home with something that they liked a little bit. So
regardless, it will be their fifth loss of the season.
And another penalty. Coach Miller and the rest of the Rams coaches were yelling at their receivers to get off of the line.
5 yard penalty still first down.
You know, that's a penalty right
there.
The
Harriton Rams have seemed to accumulated more penalties than passing yards in this game. Maybe.
That's just our guess.
They did have a nice 12-yard touchdown to Seth Lazar off the slant, but I'm pretty confident when I say there have been more than 12 penalties in this game. But we'll see.
Rothberg takes the snap out of the shotgun, rolls left, looks downfield.
Oh, good catch.
Completes to Matt Krebs.
Pass complete from Logan Rothberg.
He's a runner.
12-yard gain there.
Logan Rothberg's a runner. He's going to run around a lot. He's going to create some space, buy some time, and allow to hit a quick strike to Matt Krebs. You know, something that if quarterback who rolls out, they should really utilize something like a naked bootleg. Allows the quarterback to get into space and find maybe like a tight end or something.
And the Rams there with the completion.
The cheerleaders are saying maroon and white.
They are going to give him the first.
Short of the first down marker.
And the
he is short by a yard.
And the LM cheerleaders are
going maroon. Maroon and white. You know, they are maroon. I believe the NBA draft starts at 8, not 7.
Is that correct?
I think that's correct.
I looked it up and I thought it said 7.
Maybe coverage starts at 7.
That may be. Oh, and Rothberg with a good run there. Oh, and there seems to be a little chipperness going on.
Chipperness.
Multiple
I like that word. Chipperness. Chipperness.
And quite
like the tight ends
penalties.
Do. Chip. Chipperness. And another flag on the play.
And
I think we are probably averaging about a flag every, three plays?
Maybe in the fourth quarter, maybe even less than that.
Right. It's definitely been not a pretty sight here in the fourth quarter. Hey, listen, the third quarter was a point of emphasis to acknowledge for
the
Harrison Rams.
That's right. The third quarter, if the rest of the game had gone the way the third quarter did for the Rams, they would be smiling right now. They'd be feeling good. Because, again, the third quarter was all about the Rams, but the rest of the game, the first half, and now this fourth quarter have really been all LM. Harriton hasn't been able to get much going on. And with all these penalties, it's really just a killer to any sort of momentum that Harriton or LM, for that matter, is trying to build. And with the penalty there, the refs are still deliberating because, again, it looked like unnecessary roughness on either team. Could be, but seems as if the call is going to be against Harriton.
We're approaching the 1 minute.
We are
51.
Under 2 minutes.
Under 2 minutes. It's definitely just been a dominating performance from Lower Merion. And who knows if they're even if this team is planning on taking Ridley this Friday. I personally can't imagine they will, but just given the situation that we are living in and experiencing and how we've been sent home because of the coronavirus.
It's been a very tough season for both of these teams, really. And Rothberg takes the snap.
Drop back far.
Very far drop back. Finds his receiver, Krebs. Has a few blocks. He's at the 20. He's at the 15. 10. 5. Touchdown. Harriton Rams.
And call it Matt Krebs.
What a play there from
that's
the
a second.
Rams
well, even
offense.
Even if I said before that the Rams have had more penalties than passing yards, I think that's pretty much been eliminated there with that touchdown pass. That's a second of the day. It's just going to be a quick screen pass. off the left side. You got to get it to him in space. Rothberg's going to roll out to his direction. Defense has to be anticipating that. And obviously they lose coverage on him. He's able to out-muscle them, outrun them, and put up six. And this is the first time that the Harriton Rams, we've said this earlier in the broadcast, they've never broken more than 10 points. They've always had single digits. They put up 20 points in this game.
Now, you have to think that something is up maybe with the Harriton kickers.
Right, right.
Because
they've gone for two just about every time.
Every single time.
This Harriton team is. I guess they're going to make it a
20-point
game. And
they're going to be throwing it, trying to go with the same play as before. Ellen was pretty much expecting it. And
no
Molino
good.
Just did not have so the arm to do it.
A little bit of trickery.
Trying to go with some trickery. You know, I thought spooky season was over. Apparently not.
I thought that too. That's interesting. I mean, now we're approaching, like, you know, Thanksgiving, and that's going to come up soon. So Turkey Day.
Thanksgiving. You know, feeling a little different this year because
of
the pandemic.
Absolutely.
But still, lots to be thankful for. And, you know, I'm going to
be thankful. Detroit Lions.
Like the Detroit Lions. We can all be thankful for the Detroit Lions. We can all be thankful that this game will soon be over. It is quite cold out.
And you really want to go home and watch Anthony Edwards get drafted number one by the Minnesota Timberwolves.
I do want to watch the NBA draft. It is quite compelling.
I am glad your mock trial meeting went well and that you're here, though.
My mock trial meeting did go well.
Your mock draft.
I am a lawyer. But you know what?
I am a lawyer.
But you know what? I'm here now. That's all that matters. And you know what? 1 minute, 30 seconds left. Could we see some sort of miracle? Miracle at the Ferg Dome?
Maybe go an onside kick, though, like in order to try to get the ball. I mean, they're not, but, you know, you could have.
The Rams certainly could have tried to onside kick there. They did not.
Have you ever played football on this field before?
I have played football on this field before.
Like,
you know,
as
sort
in,
of
like,
out of
backyard
rec
football.
League,
right.
You know. But,
you know,
but
we're not,
not
talk,
with helmet
yeah,
pads.
Right. We're not talking, like, NFL,
but
right?
But let me tell you, I have made some very good throws on this field.
I think they got it. I think, yeah.
You know, hopefully one day I'll put this arm to good use.
One day, when you lace him up.
That's right. If the Harriton Rams ever need me, I will be there.
Except in the phone call.
That's right. I have my ringer on to make sure that I don't miss the phone call.
Okay. That is nice.
As you can tell, fans, we are somewhat running out of things to say. It's been a long game.
Three receivers now, or a four receiver set, one in the slot.
Haynes takes it.
It's a quick throw to the screen.
Ooh. Tries to toss it to Booker. He gets absolutely smashed there by number 12, Lazar.
Yeah, that's a screen concept. You're going to throw to your slot receiver. Sometimes they do this thing where they come out in three wide, where they motion their slot receiver behind the quarterback, and then they throw a quick screen to him, and hopefully you can get him out into some space. But,
correction there, the pass was to Declan Mack, the freshman.
Declan Mack, the freshman.
Indeed. And it does seem as though the Harriton boys soccer team is still here, and there seems to be a different soccer team. I'm not sure which, but both, you know, just staying ready to take the field as soon as the game is over.
Under center, three receivers set now, and they're just going to go down to the
knee. And they're going to take a knee, and it looks as though Meller
is going to write the ship to this one.
Not going to call a timeout here. He understands the situation. He is just going to let the clock die.
I think you got to be proud of your guys here. Obviously not the outcome that you would have wanted against your inner district rival, but they put up 20 points. That's the first time they've broken single digits. So I think it's I think you got to be proud. You got to be happy with how your team performed, especially in the third quarter. But overall, it just hasn't really been the best. As they
line up again in victory formation, and as we mentioned before, this rivalry very storied.
Right, right.
And you know, one of the great stories of this rivalry coming in the form of last year's win from Harriton
to the end of the game.
Right.
You know, Harriton beating LM 20-0. Now, LM getting their revenge back on the Rams. And
so this would essentially tie the series. Tie the series at 1-1.
That's right. Tying the series, even though
in the recent 2 years.
In the last 2 years, the series is now tied between these two teams. And as we can see,
hit triple zeros.
Even though it was quite a chippy one here tonight, the two teams are still friendly with each other.
Absolutely. I think, you know, most of these guys, you know, this is an inter-district rival. So most of these guys, they go all the way back to elementary school, middle school.
That's right. They've been playing with each other since they were very young.
Right. Nothing but respect between these two teams, and they're obviously going to do that.
They're not supposed to be shaking hands. They are shaking hands a little bit.
Even though they've been contacting the whole game, but.
That is correct. And, you know, really an interesting game from both teams. Both teams at times looked like the driving force. It was not completely one-sided for the whole time, which, you know, really made it an interesting game. And for some of these seniors, like Teddy Molyneux, this was their last time playing LM. So, you know, they definitely wanted to come out with a win, but they did get the win last year. And like we said, it was an encouraging sign from this football team in order to get to 20. They
haven't
even
just,
gotten to
10
in a previous game.
They just fight so hard, this team, and the way they compete, the way these kids just love the game of football. You know, obviously, us being students here, we know some of these kids personally.
That's Some of them in my very own physics class.
I actually see Matthew Vonderhyde.
Anyway, the final score here is the LM Aces 42, Harriton Rams 20. Here at the Ferg Dome, Ferg Turf, I'm being told by my producer, Adam Gilbert, it is the Ferg Turf. For Jason Wexler, I am Eli Feldman. From all of us here at HHSCV, we wish you a good night, and thank you for watching this edition of the Harriton LM boys football team.
Shout out Noah Zeller.